All right.
Oh, man.
All right, my friends, I've got the brackets here now. Because there is an uneven number of people taking part, okay, it means one guy gets a free pass. Now, I'm using the website called Challenge, and basically you put everybody's name in, and then you can shuffle the seeds all around, and then it sets the brackets up for me. So I'm going to post a link to the brackets. Now, I have no control over this, guys. The reason why I'm saying it is because the guy that gets the free pass is 104 Spade. Now, I haven't set that up, all right? Fair enough, I am biased. I'll be honest, I want to see Spade win, all right? But I'm going to post a link for you so you guys can see for yourself. Please believe me, guys, that this is... I have no control over this, unfortunately, so just bear with me.
Of course.
You had to prove that.
Yes. I mean, I will take it.
Yes. All right, my friend, you can click on the link. So first up, we're going to have Breeze taking on Gen Dude. Then we're going to have Mr. Assists fighting Squirtle. Then Challenger and my man Tolo V. I've got you, buddy. I've got you. And then the man, the myth, the legend, Migsubishi is taking on Havco. Then we have Hannibal taking on Hawk. Higgy versus Coyote. And then Bullet versus... Is it Adam Akbar or is it just ADM Akbar? Surely it's Adam.
Admiral Akbar.
Admiral, sorry. God damn it, Maverick. I hear you, sir. I hear you loud and clear.
You have not Star Wars yet? What the fuck?
And then Spade's going to be fighting the winner of Breeze and Gen Dude. So we're going to do it two matches at a time, all right? So you guys will be able to watch in spectators or watch on the stream. So I'm going to get the server set up now, and the first guys that are going to be fighting is Breeze versus Gen Dude, and then Mr. Assists versus Squirtle. We'll get those two matches done and out the way, and then it'll be Challenger and Tolove, and then Migsubishi and Havco. Everybody good with that?
Yeah, did you say it's okay to have the stream up, man, as long as we're not fighting?
Of course, sir, yeah. You're not going to be able to stream snipe on old streamy poos, so come at me. Come at me, sir.
No, all right. Thank you, sir.
I think I'll fall into
be back in 1 minute.
Copy. All right, I'm just getting the server set up now, chaps.
Okay, I'm back, guys. Sorry.
Welcome stream, welcome guys, sorry I'm not ignoring you, I'm just trying to multitask and I'm doing a horrible job at it. Welcome along guys to Golden Eagle, Top Gun Golden Eagle, and we're taking the bright and the best from the DCS Eagle community and putting them together in a guns only matchup. So I am just getting the mission uploaded to the server, we'll get that saved and then we'll get you guys in. I've posted the link in the chat for you guys to also check out the brackets and see who's fighting who.
Challenger is coming. I'm just calling him.
Okay.
We got some known issue about connecting to the 104
team. That's okay, dude.
As you know. And you give me the information of Challenger must be fight against who I give.
Yeah, just click on that link, bro. Click on the link and then send your friend the link so he can see.
Okay.
All right, Squirtle's done.
That's right.
How you doing, Mark?
Thank you so much. How are you, sir?
What's up, guys? Good to see you. Good to see you. Welcome back. I got my Wild Weasel swag on. My VF1 Squadron hoodie, bro. Wildweaselapparel.com, guys. Get yourselves checked out. Get yourselves checked out, guys. Right, let's just make sure everything's set up on a server properly. Game master.
Okay, I have to ask, is anyone else using VR?
Yeah, me.
Yeah, the guy who got a free pass. Oh, sorry. Inside thoughts.
Spade and Bullet are both on VR.
Absolutely no advantage in close-in dogfighting with guns at all.
No.
I gotta get my towel to wipe all the sweat off my body. Now I'm ready.
Sell that towel after, bro. We'll put it on for auction. We'll auction it on the stream.
Alright, sweet.
Alright, guys, the server's starting up. I'll put the password in the chat. Please don't say the password out loud, guys, because I am streaming. And everybody will hear it. Every man and his dog will be in the server. So I'm going to pop it in the chat. What we'll do is if you can join the server, if you want to join the server, I've put in enough spectator slots for us all to get in and just watch. So the first guys that are fighting, like we said, the first match is going to be Breeze and Gen Dude, and it's going to be Mr. Assists and Squirtle. So I want those four guys basically in the slots now. Breeze and Mr. Assists, you guys go on blue for the first one, and Jen, Dude, and Squirtle, you guys go on red for the first one, okay? Now, you don't have to swap sides if you don't want to. If you do want to swap sides in between the rounds, that's fine. And remember, it's a best of three. Now, we're going to leave it up to you guys to restart the rounds, okay? So do your first round, and then both of you coordinate between each other to say, right, go back to spectators, spawn 3, 2, 1, spawn in, and then you both spawn in again and run at each other. And remember, you must merge at 5,000 feet, okay?
All right,
so I'm going to put Squirtle. On you go, sir. Yep, I'm going to pop this. I'm going to give you the password in just a second, if I can even remember what I set it as. Hold on.
What map is that?
Caucasus.
All right. The password's in the chat. So get yourself in the server, and can I get Eons and Tiger? Can you start sorting people into the channels? So channel 1 should be Breeze and Gen Dude. Channel 2 should be Mr. Assists and Squirtle. And guys, if you have any questions while the event's going on, please don't send me a message because I won't be able to read it. See Tiger or Eons instead, okay?
All right, so just a quick question. We just start fighting as soon as we're both in?
Join in, and then just what we'll do, right, is we'll do like a quick warm-up, so you can join in and just fly around for like a minute or two, get yourself warmed up, and so you're not going to black out or anything, and then you'll go back to spectators, and then Tiger or Eons will actually start the match for you. Okay.
Okay.
All right, so Eons, you go with channel 1, Tiger, you go with channel 2.
I've got Tiger.
Roger. All right, Godspeed, guys. Good luck to everyone.
Channel switch.
Right, chat. Right, guys. Sorry to keep you waiting, my friends. This goddamn camera. My nudes are right behind me, guys. I really got to make sure that green screen doesn't get too far to the side and you guys get sculpted on some nudes. So just bear with me, folks. All right, we're going to get set up now and I'll get in the server as well. So just bear with me. I'll be back with you as quick as I can. DCS, let's get the old headset on. Have I even got TrackIR running? Yes, because I'm a trained professional. No, Angels, I'm the commentator, bro. I'm too old for this shit. I'm way too old for this, bro. Those days are long gone, dude. Those days are over. I'm like, what's his face? Fucking Charles Barkley. Do you know what I mean? Was good when he was younger. Just as a commentary now. Just as a commentary. I'll put my back out. Exactly, bro. I got a sore back. I can't be dealing with this drama. What do you think this is, bro? A game? All right, guys. Got to give a quick shout out to our sponsors at Wild Weasel. They're bringing up some swag for the winners. So, first place gets 3 t-shirts of their choice. Second place gets 2 t-shirts. And the bro that comes in third place gets his pick of a single t-shirt. So there's lots of swag there at Wild Weasel. You can get yourself 25% off as well, guys, if you want to get yourself on there. Get something nice. We've got t-shirts for the ladies and all sorts in there. 25% off with the code Maverick. All right, let's get me in the server without broadcasting the password to everyone. That would be helpful. Holy shit, there's 13 bros in it. Come on. Refresh. Oh, this goddamn coronavirus. I'm kidding on, guys. That's not funny. Someone will get upset. Don't make any coronavirus jokes. God damn it. So that's what I need. Right, so pretty straightforward in terms of what we're doing today, guys. It's a 1v1 competition. So to start off with in the preliminary rounds, we are going to be having two matches basically playing at once here. So I'll try and flick through both matches. Once we get towards like the finals, quarterfinals, semifinals and that stuff, that's when we'll do one match at a time. And we'll be able to see all the footage there. But for these first rounds, guys, we'll be jumping between bros. So I'm in a Game Master slot, get myself sorted and in here.
Almost any tournament that's streamed.
Channel switched.
Can you get Tiger? Can you jump up and tell me when this match officially starts?
I have a small problem. I cannot connect to the server.
Alright, who can't find it?
Squirtle's in.
Who is it? Assist.
Tiger can't connect.
Oh, you can't connect, Tiger. Ah. Oh, why can't you connect, bro?
My connection, it seems, is a little bit terrible. I restarted the router before.
Alright, okay. Hold on.
Buddy was moving.
Nate, are you there, bud?
I'm here, bud, yeah.
Can you help? Tiger's getting some problems getting in the server. Can you hop in and be the referee for this match, please?
Sure.
Thanks, man. So, start it when they're ready, and then just send me a message to let me know when it starts. The first aircraft to run out of fuel loses, okay? So, if the fight goes on for quite a long, just start hawking them for fuel. Do you know the password? Don't say it out loud.
No, I do not.
All right, send
just
it to you.
Give it to me.
There you go, bro. Godspeed.
Thanks.
Any skill at flying helicopters?
Eons, can you pop up and let me know when this match officially starts?
Yep, right. We're ready whenever you're ready.
All right, so all right, guys. I'll tell you what. I'll just look for you guys respawning, and then I'll start the coverage. Okay.
Okay, Roger that.
Good
so
luck,
we
guys.
Just respawn.
Yep.
Channel switched.
Right. We're off, guys. We're off. We're out of the gate. We are out of the gate. DCS capture with the face bomb. Here I am. I'm in the dark though. Where's DCS? Ah, oh, there's him. Thank God she's back. All right, let's get this show on the road, guys. Show on the road. So first up, we're going to have my main man, fucking forgot his name, Mr. Assists, taking on Squirtle. This is Squirtle's first ever event. So hold on, we need to wait for Mr. Assists to respawn. In fact, it's Breeze and Gen Dude, sorry, that are first. Breeze and Gen Dude are going to be first, guys. So these guys are just sort of warming up. We're letting these guys have a little fly around and warm up just so they're not coming in and they're too rusty. All right, guys, here we go. Boom. We have I think this is the Eclipse Task Force from 101. My man Breeze taking on Gen Dude. Let's turn this frown upside down. Let's see what they got, guys. Let's see what they got. Oh, Johnny Slick moves. Right, so we're going to go on board with Gen Dude into the merge. Both aircraft start with 90% fuel. 450 knots at 5,000 feet. Now the rule for the tournament is both aircraft must merge at 5,000 feet, guys. That's the merge altitude that we're working with. Now they can do whatever they want before the merge, but they must merge with each other at 5,000 feet. Right, good luck to you both, sirs. Good luck to you both. So there's no fire in before the merge. Not really a lot of pre-merge manoeuvring here. I was expecting to see a lot more G-loading. Not really too much on the old pre-manoeuvres, but these guys are trained professionals. They know what they're doing. All right, here comes the merge at 5. Nice, clean merge. All right, it looks like... Shit, who's the other guy? It looks like Breeze is electing to go up. Gen Dude's going to stay low. Breeze wants to come up over the top so he gets that look down, shoot down. Wants that handy god coming back for him on the way down. Looks like he is tally visual on our man Gen Dude. Gen Dude sort of loading up the G here, kicking around about the 8G mark. There comes 9, he sees him coming in. He's electing to go up way close to 500 knots, so he is above corner. Breeze coming out with a long range shot. The F-15 cannon, absolutely deadly. It's basically a laser on the front of that aircraft. So Breeze definitely finding himself in a driving position now, although Gen Dude's not out of fight now. He is below corner speed, we're down to 320 odd knots now. Trying to get that nose back up. Breeze looks like he's doing the salmon a little bit down there, but looks like that's under control now. Some decent aspect going on here. Gen Dude electing to go low. Really slow on the airspeed now. Fight's getting slower. We're down below 300 knots for a second. Now he's coming back up. So rolling around each other. Geometry's very neutral right now. Both pilots, I'd say, at this stage, guys, very evenly matched. I'm surprised at how quickly the fight slowed down. I was expecting to see like guys sticking around corner, 450 knots, that sort of regime. Here's a good opportunity for Gen Dude. A nice snapshot opportunity crossing. Oh, he takes a taste! He might want another one. Takes a little taste. But Breeze just shrugs that off. The F-15's a big girl, she can take it. Gen dude again working himself out of the driving seat. We are a little bit low on energy. Both aircraft, I think, down below 300 knots, so the fight is getting slow. Gen dude needs to just squat the jet now. That's it, bro. Just squat it, bro. Get that nose moving. Get the nose moving. Finish him. He's all over it. He is all over it. There it is. There it is. Great first round. Oh, I fucking collided with him, bro. That is a total disaster. Oh my god. That's going to be one apiece, guys. That has to be one apiece. Surely that's going to be one apiece. Yep, he is not going to recover from that shit. Good god. Good god, right. It looks like we got Colt, who is Mr. Assist, taking on Squirtle. I'll just want to check TeamSpeak to verify. Disregard. Disregard. So drama. Drama out the gate, guys. Drama out the gate. Right, here we go. Mr. Assists, Colt 5-1, taking on Squirtle. Here we go. Both aircraft, again, not too heavy on the pre-merge manoeuvring. Both aircraft must merge at 5,000 feet. We're giving them a little bit of wiggle room here, about 250 feet unofficially, so... Alright, Squirtle elects to go up. Mr. Assist wants to stay in the horizontal plane and turn with him. Squirtle banks in a lot of energy. He's way down below 260 knots already. Obviously wants that nose authority just to maybe try and get in the fight earlier. This is a great shot opportunity coming up right here. Ah, oh, unlucky, dude. Unlucky. So Assist is going to go down to try and recover that energy that he lost when he had to come up and fight him. Squirtle's going to go back down and recover some energy. So both pilots sort of in the same game plan right now. Oh, what a beautiful head-on shot from Squirtle. Right in the face. Is Assist going to be able to recover from that? I don't think so. He's leaking fuel and stuff is burning. And it's not my toast. Ah, Squirtle. Squirtle takes the first one. Out punches Mr. Assist. So it's best of three, guys. Best of three. So, Mr. Assist has got a chance to come back from that. Alright, let's jump on board with Breeze this time. We went into the merge last time with Gen Dude. So Breeze working up that G-tolerance. Very sensible idea to be doing. Shaking and baking. Getting ready for the riggedy roll. Great flying by the Squirtster. Alright, still just a little outside 5 miles from each other, so I can't see him just yet on F5. Here we go. So Breeze, chilling out at 5,000 feet, he's doing 500 knots. So he's not crazy fast. But he definitely is on the quicker side of things. Sorry about the green screen, guys. Here we go, into the merge, 5,000 feet. Nice pedestrian merge. No pilot really panicking or any sense of urgency, really, to be honest. Both pilots electing to turn with it rather than go up. Pretty neutral geometry. Both pilots look like they're doing a good job of looking after the energy here. No one sort of down below corner. I think Breeze has lost sight on him. Breeze just rolls back right in and gives him his ass. That is not good, bro.
Negatory.
That is not good. Now, Gen Dude's going to be all over this. This is a big chance for him to claw back here. Great shooting opportunity coming. Maybe he needs to slow that jet down now. This looks like an overshoot. So he looks like he's doing a sort of loop moving for lag pursuit, but he's showing some nice patience here. I'm not sure what Breeze is doing. I don't think Breeze sees him. I think Breeze does not have a visual. I think if he'd seen him by now, he would have been nose down. Maybe he just got a little spot of him there. It's a big opportunity for Gen Dude. He's going to try and get out of the way. Doing a good job here. He really wants to stay out of that lift plane. That's what it's all about. You want to stay out of that lift vector so that he can't get that guns on you. And right now he's doing a great job, but... Gen Dude, with everything to do in the back. Breeze looks like he could possibly force an overshoot here. Gen Dude looks like he's getting too close. Here comes the overshoot, guys. Great flying by both pilots. We've got an in-close scissors going on here. Now they're going to start rolling around each other. I think Breeze is the guy in the position to be right now. If he can get track on him, if he can... Where is he? He's right below us. He's right below us, and he's reversed it. Good job. But Gen dude has the energy. He's looked after his energy. Breeze is not going to be able to follow him up, so... Actually, Breeze is in a lot of trouble right now. Gen dude has managed to look after his energy a little bit better. Now he's coming down with a hand of God. And Breeze is in big trouble. This is... Could be game over for Breeze here. Gen dude just needs to squat the jet again. Go for the shot now, dude. Had a little snapshot opportunity there. Didn't take it. Hopefully that's not going to cost him. I still think Gen dude's in the driving seat here. Again, just needs to squat the jet. Doesn't need to be burning here. That's it. Just squat it up, bro. There we go. Some nice hits. All right. The right engine is on fire. Breeze, you're on fire, sir. And not in a good way. Oh, that looks like a wing maybe just departed there. It is indeed. And Breeze maybe trying to get a little bit lucky with a little snatch on the way down. It's not going to pay off. Great flying by both pilots. All right, let's hop on board back again with Mr. Assists and Squirtle. So we went with Mr. Assists last time. We'll hop in with Squirtle this time. What's up, DJ Ken? Welcome along, guys. Welcome. Sorry if I miss any questions or anything on the stream. I got to sort of make this my main focus, guys. All right, so both pilots, again, not really too crazy on the G warm-ups here. Very pedestrian going into the merge, but hey, I'm not judging them. Nice little merge at 5,000 feet. Squirtle likes to take it one circle, doesn't want to do the two circle. He's going to try and get some head-on shots here, I think. I'm calling it right now. It's going to be a head-on pass. Oh, and he nails him! He nails him! Definite hits there, definite hits. I think we're just... I think he maybe got a little taste of us. Not seeing any damage, but good God, that was close. So Squirtle, out the gate. Just heavy aggression, heavy aggression. It looks like Breeze is missing a vertical stabilizer. He's looking like a bit of Swiss cheese there. Squirtle with some great energy management on the way down. Pretty slow though, but again, it's not always about being fast and being high energy. Sometimes you just want to squat the jet, get that nose moving. Oh, and Breeze comes back. Squirtle is now choking out black stuff out the back of the jet. See, guys, never give up. Never, ever give up. The fight's over when it's over. So we're down here, low energy fight. Squirtle definitely in the driving seat. If he can get these early guns out, he put him under pressure. Shots, hits, hits, hits. Down he goes. Down he goes. Great flying. Great flying. That was a good one. So I think that's it. I think Squirtle's is through. Right, let's get on board with Breeze. So this should be the final matchup between Breeze and Gen Dude here. Alright, Breeze electing to go up. Gen Dude wants to keep it low. And again, Breeze is back. Breeze has just cashed it all in, bro. We're down below 180 knots, fam. We're doing the salmon. Some extremely ambitious shots coming out from a man Breeze, but hey, you never know. You never know. God loves a tryer. We're still doing the salmon. Gendu just needs to be patient here. Not panic and just look after his energy and outrate this guy. He fucking hit him, bro! Oh my God! Holy shit, dude! He takes him down! Oh my God, bro. That is some Shooter McGavin stuff right there, bro. That is some Shooter McGavin stuff. Holy shit. That was impressive. That was impressive, guys. Didn't start off too well, but good God, he made that work. Squirtle wins 2-0. Nice. Channel switch. All right, bud, can you get the next round?
Yes, I'm taking now the next round.
Thanks, man. Channel switched. Good God, guys. Good God. So it looks like Squirtle's definitely through. So we'll update the scoreboards here. So Squirtle goes through. So how do I do this? Match details. Squirtle wins. Come on, man. Let me enter this. Why won't it let me enter it? Come on. Start the tournament. Maybe that's why I'm having it. God damn it. If you guys want to check out what we're doing with brackets and stuff, if you're just joined on the stream and you didn't get the link before, click on that link. So my man Squirtle is through. The winner is Squirtle. So Squirtle's through. Squirtle's going to fight the winner of Challenger and Tolove. And we're still waiting to see who the winner is between Breeze and Gendude. So the winner between these two guys fights the man, the myth, the legend, 104 Spade. You know you're doing well when some kid starts a thread about you on Reddit accusing you of hacking, which is exactly what happened to Spade. One of the most genuinely nice guys, one of the most players with like the most amount of integrity in the game. Helps a lot of people. He's just been rock solid for years. He's been an absolute fighting machine in the F-15 for the past 10 years that he's been in DCS. And yeah, it's all. When people start accusing you of hacking, guys, that's when you know you're doing something right. All right, we're on board with Breeze, fucking Shooter McGavin here. Let's see if he can do it again. I think he's going to go for the same program. He's going to go up. Good God, yes, he's going to go up. He's going to squat that jet. I think Gendude maybe is wise to the plan. It is Gendude. We'll jump on board with Gendude. Gendude's maybe wise to the slow shooter plan here. Gendude about 100 knots slower than corner. He needs to be careful here. Get that nose down, dude, if you're going to get out of the way. So a great job to get out of the way, and it looks like again shooting McTootin in the back here. Well, just wants to keep slow. He's not too worried about the energy fight. He's just going to keep slow and stay inside his circle. And put him under pressure with these laser cannons. This is real risky for Gendude to go up like that, I think, because he's going to run out of energy around about now. And that's when he's going to struggle to get out of the way at this point. I'm not saying he's doing it wrong, I'm just saying I would maybe feel a bit more comfortable turning in the horizontal plane at this point, rather than going up. And he has paid the price for it, unfortunately. Stuff is coming out of our aircraft, and Mr. Breeze is just fucking on it, bro. Look at him, he's, do you know what I mean, really working all those control surfaces. You can tell that he's slow as shit, but he's happy with that, guys. He's happy just to be slow, stay inside the no turn circle, and take his shots. Gendude trying to recover some airspeed here, and again, he's going up. I'm not trying to tell the guy that he's doing it wrong, but I think he's making it harder for himself by going up. I would be wanting to bring the fight down at this point. I'd want to hit the hand of God helping me to get out the way and then start rating him in the turn. Roll over, bro, and pull! Oh, come on, man. Put him out of his misery. I think both pilots are just trying to recover energy as best they can here. But it looks like I can never remember the name. It looks like the Breeze Master is just lining up the shots. A Breeze elects to roll out! That is risky. Gendude, this is Gendude's big opportunity here to make him pay for this. And he's not really recovering that much speed, guys. We're still below corner speed. Still way below corner speed. 270 knots, bro. This is a big chance for Gendude. This is a huge opportunity for him here. He needs to slow down. Don't overshoot, bro. Don't overshoot. He's done a good job there. He's done a good job at hanging on to that. He needs to get his lag pursuit sorted out now. And fly inside the bandit's bubble. Doesn't want to go too heavy on the lead here or pure. This is a great shooting opportunity, brother. It doesn't get to look any better than this. Breeze is now starting to load up the knots on the jet. We're up at 500 knots, which is where the Eagle wants to be. He might be trying to run him out of fuel. So I think Gendude definitely will be leaking fuel. That's what all this mist is. Coming out the back of his aircraft. Great shooting opportunity for Gen. Needs to get some yellow rice out just to start putting Breeze under a bit of pressure to force him to make a mistake. The F-15 cannon is insanely accurate, so any sort of shots you see coming at you, do you know what I mean? You're always thinking, shit, that's going to hit me in the face. See, right now, Gen just needs to be throwing out bits of rice at him here to put him under pressure. It's got so much ammunition in that aircraft. That's it, bro. Just start taking little bites, bro. Little tastes. Oh, don't do that, dude. Breeze needs to be careful here. He's very high on energy. He could black out. This is a big danger here. He could black out and send himself into the fish. But he's doing a good job with like the sort of high energy reset here. I don't know if I'd be doing that. But hey, I'm not judging him. Right, so is the other match underway yet? We do have another match up on going to the top, so I think this one is almost sort of coming to fruition, guys. I'm going to quickly jump on board with Challenger and Tolovey, and it looks like Challenger has taken a little taste out of Tolovey. Tolovey's still in it. We see some black smoke coming out there, which is not good. We do have some control surfaces missing on the Eagle. But like we said, she's a strong, independent woman, so she's going to shrug that off. She can take a slap or two. Challenger getting real slow here with some heavy nose up as well. I'm not sure if I'd be doing that. I'd want my nose below the horizon, recovering this energy, and rolls out right in front of him. Turned out to be the right move. Nice rolling scissors here. Opportunity for Tolovey. Maybe get a quick snapshot on the pass back. I would go up. That's it, bro. Go up. Challenger, good job at squatting the jet there. And he takes a bite out. Tolovey takes another taste. Loves it. Both aircraft with some serious problems here. Challenger doing a fantastic job of just getting out the way. This is the point where you want to be slow. You want to just slow the aircraft down. You need to have enough power to turn, but... This is a good... Someone's dying here. Ah, oh, bro, tastes. Both aircraft landing hits there, I think. Not enough to take each other out of the sky, though. This is all Tolovey right here. This is all Tol. Oh, that's a risky reversal. Tolovey needs to roll the aircraft. Just roll, bro. Roll it! Ah, maybe not nose down. Ah, bro. Nah, yeah, that was the wrong call. Still in the driving seat, though. Again, slow energy fight. We're down below 300 knots. Eagle corner speed is around about 450 knots. She's a high energy fighter. I mean, she does do well on the high AOA sitch, but really she wants to be setting the world on fire. 450, 440, 500 knots. Very neutral geometry here right now. I think it's going to take a little moment to maybe sort that out. And it looks like Gen Dude took it, bros. Well done. Hold on a second. I'll quickly jump in with this one again then. Channel switch. Is that the round, guys?
Yeah, Gen 1.
Roger. Great fights, both of you guys. Congratulations, Gen. Great fighting.
Thank you.
Thanks, Breeze.
No problem. Channel
switch. Right, so I'll update the scores. So Gen Dude gets through. Winner, select. So Challenger and Tolovey, still very neutral. Tolovey electing to do something different and start changing the geometry of the fight, the plane he wants to fight at. Possibly looking at a high-low yo-yo here. But Challenger's just going to follow him up and do the same thing. Challenger looks like he's warping out a little bit. Oh, this doesn't look good. Unfortunately, my man's from Iran, so... looks like we've got some Iranian internet connectivity issues here, guys. Because Tolovey is rock solid. Unfortunately, the routing out of Iran is not that great, and I think he's actually given up the ghost. He's possibly maybe even crashed out of the server. So, winners in the first round, so we've got Gen Dude goes through to fight Spade, and Squirtle is going to fight the winner between Tolovey and Challenger. Right, let's get the rest of the matches up and running.
Seeing one guy frozen.
All right, Nighty Poos, can we get Hannibal and Hawk and Higgy and Coyote set up as well? Bullet, can you help out with this?
Yes, sir.
Cheers. Channel switched. All right, in the interest of brevity, guys, and so the stream doesn't take 9 hours, I actually have to go to work tonight as well, so I can't afford to be here for like 4 hours or something. So we're going to get a couple of more matches taking place at the same time. So unfortunately, we're not going to be able to see all the action as it happens, but I will try and keep up with most of the action as it happens. Welcome on board if you're just joining us. We are doing the Top Gun Golden Eagle event, guys. So it's a one versus one guns only competition. F-15Zo. And we've got some prizes. We've got some swag, some aviation related apparel swag coming for the winner, sponsored by our friends at Wild Weasel Apparel. So the winner gets 3 t-shirts of their choosing, second place gets 2 t-shirts, and third place gets 1 t-shirt. So we've got some aviation related swag coming out for these pros, and you can check it all out here. Well, you can check the event scores on that link, and you can get your Wild Weasel swag from here. All right, let's get back on board. It looks like we have Meg Sabishi, who is flying the wrong way for unknown reasons. Those guys might be just warming up or something like that, so I will slow my roll down. AJ Rim Tutti Tuki. What a name, sir. AJ Rim Tutti Tuki. Thank you for the follow, my friend. Welcome on board. Lozzie and Haggis have not signed up, my friend. All right, it looks like we have Tolove and Challenger coming back online. So we'll jump back on with a DCS capture. There I am. And we have, like I said, Tolove and Challenger. Hopefully my Iranian internet's going to hold up for this brother here. So we'll go on board with my man Tolove. Again, not too crazy on the pre-merge maneuvering. Quite surprised. I thought we were going to see a lot more high energy going into the old maneuver. Challenger, you need to be at 5,000 feet, dude. Channel switched. Alright, reset that, guys. Reset the match.
Okay.
Make sure he understands, Tiger. Channel switched. Alright, we're going to have to reset that because Challenger went way low. The rule is, guys, both aircraft, you can do whatever you want before the merge. You can do whatever you want. You must merge at 5,000 feet, give or take 250 feet. So we're going to reset that one. All right, we're going board with Mitsubishi and Havco. This should be a good one. So, Havco, this is United States of America versus Russia, guys. Good God. Good God. Place your bets, folks. Place your bets. So we have Havco representing Mother Russia and Mitsubishi. Well, we kind of got the names the wrong way around here. Mitsubishi's actually representing the United States of America. America! The greatest country in the world. If you haven't travelled outside it. I'm only kidding, guys. That's just a cheap joke. Sorry to my American brothers and sisters. Don't hate me, bro. Alright, both aircraft clean into the merge at 5,000. And both aircraft electing to turn rather than go up. Pretty standard stuff here. Mitsubishi looking to shake off a lot of smash off the jet. They're coming in for the one circle straight ahead. Holy shit, son! My Russian brother is just heavy on the fucking guns, trying to make that happen. Mitsubishi done a great job of just getting out of the way. Didn't even fire back, just sort of maintained his composure and stayed in it. So this is a good one, guys. This is Cold War. This is some Cold War action. So our Russian bro has gone down low. He's got the angles here. Mitsubishi might be in a bit of trouble. Need to get out of the road of this. Hup, hup. Some yellow rice coming in. Both pilots, doing the predictable turning left. Everyone loves turning left. Much more natural to push left and pull rather than pull right and pull, if you know what I mean. That's why most fights always usually end up in both aircraft turning left. Alright, kind of neutral geometry here. I see Mitsubishi really trying to get heavy with the nose down to maintain his energy. And Havco's really mirroring the same program here. Mitsubishi possibly thinking about a high-low yo-yo. Now he's going to maybe roll the nose over and start getting that nose down to get round in the back. That's exactly what I think he's going to be doing. No, he elects to roll out. That's very interesting. Rolls out just to get a little bit more smash, but then spends it again. Not really 100% sure. Havco is definitely getting the angles right now, but I still think Mitsubishi's in the strongest driving seat. So how fast is Havco going? Meg is at 420 knots. And Havco's down at 370. So Havco is struggling a little bit for energy. He'll be trying to just let off the stick a little bit, just to sort of rate that turnout. Get a little bit more smash over the jet. Again, very neutral geometry here. At this point, you sort of have to fight the temptation to really squat the jet and pull the nose in, because that's exactly what this guy's waiting for. Both pilots are just going to follow each other in a sort of merry-go-round style here. Very disciplined approach from both guys. Not getting too close to the deck. Mitsubishi doing a great job of keeping the altitude. He's been the higher guy throughout the whole fight. And he is going to elect to just take that airspeed and just go up a little bit more. It does look like Havco's starting to rate him round though, but Havco's definitely at an energy disadvantage right now. Mick is definitely the faster pilot. So if the shit starts hitting the fan, he can just hit the eject button and exit out of the fight in a vertical plane. And now there we go, there goes Havco. Remember we talked about squatting the jet and spending that energy to get some nose authority. Havco's decided to take that gamble, and that's exactly what Mick's waiting on. That's exactly what Mick is waiting on. I think Mick needs to try and identify that, his opponent's slow now. Start maybe just forcing that nose down a little bit more and start rating on that stick. This fuel's not going to last forever. Here we go now. He's starting to spend some snash. Smash even. There we go. Here comes the nose authority. I'd like to see maybe a little bit more nose down. I think it's going to come now. He's obviously very conscious. He's only got 1,000 feet of altitude to play around with here. Does a little unload just to recover some smash back over the jet. But very neutral fight here, guys. Both pilots, do you know what I mean, grew up in different countries, different cultures. Find himself here at the same place and time. Very neutral fight. This might even take a while, guys. This might take a while. This might come down to fuel. It might be time for someone to try something a bit different. This does tend to happen when you get two evenly matched pilots, guys. This does tend to happen an awful lot. A lot of people think, well, why don't you just immediately try something different? Well, the problem is, basically, both pilots are waiting for the other person to make a mistake. If you try something different, if you try and change the way the fight's going, and you fuck it up, the guy that's sitting there at corner, just hanging in there, he's going to rate right round behind you and make you pay for it. Right, we're going to check in what's going on with other people, because this is just a bit of a merry-go-round. We have Challenger taking on Tolove up here in the north, so we'll stick with this one and see how this goes. Right, we're not exactly at 5,000 feet, but we're there or thereabouts. Quite a distant merge there. So let's see. Tolove electing to go up, spending quite a lot of his energy. So again, he wants that nose authority. We've seen this happen before. We've seen this work for other pilots where they're happy to be inside the turn circle. Use it, bro, shoot! Not sure if he took full advantage of that there. Challenger with a really risky rollout there. It looked like he maybe sort of departed a little bit. I think Challenger has lost visual on him. I think he definitely doesn't see him anymore because he's not really making... Ah, he must see him now. That's a good call there, what he's doing. Tolove should be able to get a little shot opportunity here. Oh, both pilots selecting just to get on the cannon. And a lot of the times, guys, even if you don't have a good shoot cue, right, just getting some rounds out there, the guy's going to react, all right? The guy's going to see a lot of yellow rice coming at him. And he's going to do something. Most of the time. Tolove with some good airspeed. He is spending an awful lot of it now. Now we're down below corner speed. With a little bit of a wobble on. Nose down to try and recover. And Challenger's going to match him exactly. I think Tolove's going to maybe be tempted to really start squatting the jet here and get these angles. No, instead he's going to be more disciplined, unload a little bit and go up. Oh, this is looking good. Squat it now, dude, squat it. Good lad. Let's go, bro, let's go. This is all you. Challenger doing a good job of just getting out of the way. Not doing too much in terms of manoeuvring the aircraft, just holding on to the little energy that he has. Tolove needs to go heavy with that nose down. Heavy nose down, bro. Roll left and go. So Challenger, I think, spent a lot of energy to try and get out of the danger zone. He's managed to do a good job and hold on to it. I don't think Challenger's got the energy to get all the way back around behind it. This is a good shooting opportunity now for Tolove. And again, just putting him under pressure, force him to make a mistake. He's going to do something. Tolove with a little wobble on. Challenger looks like he's getting some good airspeed across that jet. Some good defensive BFM here. The fight's well above 550 knots now. Now we're into the real high energy regime of BFM. 600 knots plus for both aircraft. Pippy, pippy, pat, pat, pip. Let's go, bro. Let's put them under pressure. Little hits. Just little hits, bro. Pip, pip, pippy, pippy, pat, pat, pip. Oh, he took a taste. Took a little taste. What's another one? Hey, Flying Finn, thanks for the resub, buddy. Tier 1 for 7 months. Thank you very much, sir. I hope you're well. Oh, Hawk's in trouble. Sorry, Challenger's in trouble. I don't even think he sees him. There's no way he sees him, bro. Come on, Tolome. Pull in, dude. Pull in, Ray, bro. Get him, get him, get him. Ah! Oh, I think he's lost sight. Row, row. Oh, no, not the water, bro. Not the water. Not like this, bro. Oh, he's got him. Oh, Challenger somehow fucking falls off a boat into the sea and comes out dry. How the hell did he get out of that? A Challenger now well in the driving seat, guys. Never give up, bros. Brothers and sisters, never give up. Tolovey's in big trouble. Take it easy, dude. Take it easy. Take it easy. Just pippy, pippy, pat, pat, pip, remember. What's Challenger working with here, speed-wise? 200, yeah, just... Ah, bro. I don't know, dude. I don't know. Maybe start squatting, dude. Start squatting. I would fucking just pull now, dude. I would fucking just bury the stick in my stomach and just have a go. Because he's only getting slower. Do you know what I mean? He's not. He doesn't have enough nose down to accelerate. Oh, that's a risky reversal. I think Challenger's going to end up running out of ammo at this rate, brother. Right, don't panic. Don't panic. Tolovey working on a great reversal here. He's going to force this overshoot. Both aircraft are doing the salmon. Tolovey with some high fucking AOA shenanigans. Holy shit, son. This is a big chance for Challenger to put him down if he can turn that fucking upside down. Oh, they nearly met a collision. I don't know if that's the right way to say that. Alright, Challenger again, electing to just squat the jet and just goes for nose authority over energy, which is fair enough. If you can get the shot, bro, take it, but I think you must be low on ammo right now. Holy shit, what a fight. Tolovey coming out the driving seat now. Right, who else is fighting? Hannibal and Hawk. Let's check on board with these two guys. Sorry to invest so much time in one fight, guys, and then jump out of it before we see who the winner is. But yeah, we spent a lot of time watching those guys, so we need to make sure everybody gets a bit of coverage. So here's Hannibal rolling with another brother from Iran. This is our Iranian brother called Hawk. Very, very nice man. All the Iranian guys are great. That's one of my favourite things about DCS is doesn't matter what your political beliefs are or who you vote for or what religion you are, what colour your skin is or where you were born. Do you know what I mean? Military aviation brings us all together. And I can tell you guys, the guys from Iran are just like me and you. They're passionate about their aircraft. They love their country. And they're good people. They're genuinely good people. It's great to see them taking part in these events. So it looks like my Iranian brother Hawk is all over Hannibal. So we might see an Iranian F-15 shooting down an American F-15. You couldn't make this shit up. Hannibal with some good distracting flares there. And obviously he's not got any weapons coming at him in terms of AIM-9s, but you start chucking out some flares in a circle like that, it's going to confuse the fuck out of him. Hawk doing a great job to hang on though. Hannibal doing a good job of getting out of plane, but Hawk is holding on. Oh, what a shot. What an absolutely brilliant shot. Takes off both wingtips. And the F-15's strong, but she is not that strong. So well done to Hawk there. Great fight. Great fight. Right, these two guys have been merged for 4 hours into a 1 hour event. Let's see how this goes. Tolovey in the driving seat. I don't know if I would go up, dude. Oh, in fact, that's the right call for what he's doing right now. Now roll over and go get him. Wait. Here it is. Ah, unlucky, bro. Unlucky. Get him. This is it. Come on, bro. Ah, Challenger just doing a fantastic job of getting out of the way. Ah, bro, I would have kept on turning right. Oh, he's going to force this overshoot, guys. Tolovey just needs to calm down. He's doing a great job of staying behind him. Just needs to keep that. See, he's not using too much gas. He's not burning and turning. He's just turning. Come on, bro. Take a shot. Is he out of ammo? What the fuck is going on here? The Sea Squirrel Nation are reaching out for our man Challenger. Holy shit. Oh, in he goes. Khan, sonar. Hey, Liam, thanks for the prime, sir. Welcome. Welcome along, dude. Welcome to the stream. All right, Challenger is out. So that's a point. That's that round to Tolovey. God damn it. Right, here we go again. Russia versus America. We're on board with Mitsubishi. Head on shots. Both pilots survived. Get on board with Havco. So Meg elects to go up, Hav elects to go down. He's going to roll that nose of 40. Here comes a little taste. Pippy, pap, pap, pip. Not too much on the shots. Looking good. Very slow though. Very slow. Mitsubishi can maybe try and identify by how heavy nose down his opponent is that, hey, this bro's really fucking slow. Meg looks like he's doing a good job of keeping his energy and controlling the altitude of the fight. He's definitely in the driving seat right now. Havco well below corner speed. 450 is where she wants to be. We're down at 340 knots. Tolovey wins 2-0. Let me get these scores updated. Report scores. Tolovey wins 2-0. Alright, again, we're seeing this an awful lot, guys. We're seeing a lot of neutral geometry. All this means is that both pilots are quite equally matched. That's all it means. It doesn't mean that... an awful lot apart from... I mean, if you get two pilots with sort of similar skills, then they're going to find themselves in sort of neutral geometry, looking at each other at the same angles for a lot of the fight. And then it's going to come down to just whoever makes the first mistake, if the other guy can capitalise on that. This is a good opportunity. Oh, that's a fucking great taste. A great taste. Meg electing just to get out of plane. Massive hits from Havco though. This is looking real good. Both engines on fire for Meg. And there goes the wing, brothers and sisters. Great job for our Russian brother Havco. Well done, sir. That was some great fighting. That's some good putting power, bro. Some great putting power. So, Havco goes through. Havco goes through 2-0. Alright, next up we have Bullet taking on, it's not Adam Akbar, it's Admiral Akbar, god damn it. So this should be a good one, guys, this should be a good one. So Bullet and Adam's next, then we have Hannibal and Hawk. I think we're yet to see who wins that one, and we've got Higgy and Coyote coming up as well, of the last of the preliminary rounds. Welcome on board, guys. My name's 104th Maverick. I'm your host with the most in a burnt bit of toast. Who won the first round between these two guys? Which guys are you talking about, Phil? Sorry. Yes, yeah, so sorry I'm not doing a very good job of keeping up with the chat, guys, I'm afraid. I got to kind of make this my main focus here. But if there is any questions that you're desperate to answer, get answered, just keep asking and hopefully I will catch them in time. When will Top Gun Viper Sniper be? I'm going to announce that tomorrow, my friend. I actually should have, maybe it would have been a good idea to get that done for this stream, but yeah, I'll announce that tomorrow. So make sure you get on the ED forums, guys, and get it signed up. So we're going to do the same thing, Top Gun Viper Sniper. All right, so it's going to be F-16 versus F-16, guns only. Same setup, air starts, both aircraft must merge at 5,000 feet. That's going to be coming at you next month, and I'll get you a date at some point tomorrow. So here we go. Admiral Akbar representing the United States of America. 104th Bullet representing the United States of America. So it's an American affair here. So let's see who can... I think they're just having a quick G warm-up just to make sure nobody flies into the ground or anything. We want them to have a little bit of a throw around of the jet first before they start actually getting into combat. Oh, God. What's with all the hard names today, guys? Simplicico Maroney, thank you for the follow. Hopefully I said your name right, sir. Thank you for the follow and welcome to the channel. All right, here we have the United States of America taking on the United States of America. Don't know about the ball licking and whatever sucking that was. Not 100% sure about that, guys, but we'll jump back in with the action. So we're on board with Admiral Akbar. It's going to be going into the merge with good old Bullet. Merge is coming at 500 feet. We have Admiral at 500 knots. Bullet just at a roundabout corner speed at 460. This should be a good one, guys. I'm going to call it now. Bullet is going up. Bullet goes up. The Admiral elects to turn with him. So this is nice. So Bullet goes up for that Hawkeye position. Looks like he has managed his energy quite well. He's inside the turn circle though. He might take an early gun opportunity. Admiral Akbar identifies the danger and gets out of plane very quickly and very sensibly. Some great defensive BFM, but Bullet's got hits on the fucking board. God damn it. Bullet comes out of the gate. He's fucking killed the pilot, bro. He is dead. Round one to Bullet. God damn it. God damn it, guys. That was over quickly. That was over quickly. That was like me having sex. Hyped the fuck out of it, and it was over very, very quickly. God damn it. All right, so 1-0 to Bullet. 1-0 to Bullet. So who have we got? We've got Coyote. We're just having a little warm-up down there. Coyote's going to be fighting against my brother from Scotland, Higgy. I've never seen this guy before. But he is from Scotland, and I'm all for bringing more Scots into DCS, bros. I love seeing that. I love seeing that. So let's see who comes at us first. Maybe get some bagpipes ready. All right, let's go, guys. Come on, where's the action? Don't make me come down there. Here we go again. Looks like we're going to have Team America coming back up again. Bullet and Admiral Akbar. Now, Admiral done a great job of getting out of the plane really quickly, but Bullet just fucking... Do you know what I mean? Bullet just worked it out. Bullet just got it sorted and managed to hang on there. Right, so we'll go on board with Bullet again. I'm anticipating that Bullet's going to do the same thing. I think Bullet's going to go up, and he's going to try and get that, do you know what I mean, that look-down, shoot-down position from the top of the bird's nest where I'm a... I'm not saying that Admiral Akbar doesn't know what he's doing, all right? But I think if he doesn't follow Bullet up, I think that would be a mistake. I think he should go for, like, the one circle with the head-on pass at the top and see how that works out for him. Bullet very sensibly warming his G up. He's not flying in a straight line. He's loading that jet up with some some energy so that he doesn't go in too lackadaisical. Right, we're on board with F5. Here we go. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. So it's 1-0 to Bullet so far. Alright, Bullet's going to go up, and again, the Admiral does not elect to come up. He's sort of thinking about it. He's maybe left it a little bit too late, though. It looks like he is still very fast, though. Whoa, he's warping around a little bit. I think Bullet's lost sight on him. Bullet does not see where this guy went. Great fucking moves by the Admiral. Admiral are way up at the top of the loop at 180 knots, though. He's... What the fuck's going on with the pings? Oh, maybe my man Hawk. Now, hopefully that's not going to have too much of a... Ah, it's happening again. Alright, we're going to... We'll leave this for a little minute and see if it settles down. If not, we'll restart this round. Alright, Bullet sees him. Bullet's got eyes on him now. Looks like the... warping is slowly working itself out. Bullet very slow, 180 knots, I seen it at one point. This is a good shooting opportunity for him here, though. I think he is going to spend which energy, little energy he has, just to get that nose authority. The Admiral is rolled out right in front of him. Risky business. Risky business. Bullet getting the days of thunder. How many more fucking Tom Cruise quips can he come out with, bro? Bullet's the top gun. My man, Admiral, is going to see that rain, man. He is going to see that rain, man. All right, I'll stop it now. I will stop it now. Right, so Bullet goes through. Reasonably convincingly as well. God damn. Bullet takes it. Bullet is through. Before you check. Yeah. Submit scores. Scores. Bullet wins 2-0. So Bullet goes through, ladies and gentlemen. Right, so we're waiting for Higgy and Coyote. Where's my Scottish brother Higgy? Hannibal and Hawk. We're waiting on Hannibal and Hawk and Higgy and Coyote. You shut up, Knight! Fucking buster, how dare you? Me and TC are fucking close, bro. TC knows. Me and TC. Look, bro. Do you want me to look? Look. Where is it? He's right there, bro. That's how fucking close me and Tom Cruise are, dude. He's in my fucking ready room. Don't give me any goddamn. Fucking bastard. Right, so it looks like it's going to be Higgy and Coyote next. I'm not desperate, alright, but I am really looking forward to seeing how my man Higgy flies. It's always great to have another Scotsman. We're slowly taking over the fucking world here. We got myself, Bonnie Prince Commie, Spectre, who else? Who else is Scottish and in the game? I think there's more than three of us. Surely there's more than three of us. What's the coffee sitch? God damn it. Alright guys, I'm very quickly going to get a drink of water. I'll be right back. Oh, we're on. It looks like Spade and Jen, dude, are up, so that is, like, this is going to be Spade's first match, but it's going to be Jen, dude's second match. And again, if you want to check out the scores and stuff, guys, click on this link. So I'm going to put you on board with Spade, and I'm going to quickly get a glass of water. Oh, wrong one. This one. So I can get F5, but just before I click the run to the kitchen so you guys don't miss anything. Hey, Shake, thanks for the resub, dude. Oh, god damn it, the one time I can't hear it, I got my headphones off. Where were you, Shake? You were supposed to be in here, bro. Where the fuck were you? This was all you, dude. This was all you. Alright, I'll be right back. Right, Spadykin's electing to go up. Spade definitely in the driving seat. Definitely in the driving seat. Who's he fighting again? Jen dude, that's right. Although Jen dude looks like he's in a high state of BFMness. 8 months of hell and damnation, you said to me, Shake. Thanks, brother. The happiest 8 months of my life. Alright, old Spadykin's in the driving seat here. Again, just need to squat the jet now, start getting some fucking rounds out. This is a kill. This is a kill. 100%. Nice. Takes a taste. Doesn't want to get too greedy here. Just slow it down, brother. Slow it down. This is all you, dude. Stuff's coming out the back. He's panicking. He's flaring everything. Oh, what a shot, bro. What a shot.
Affirmative.
Oh, and there goes the wing. There goes the wing. So 1-0 to Spadykins. 1-0 to the man, the myth, the legend. Where's my fucking bro Higgy at? Maybe if I play some fucking bagpipes, he'll show up. Hey, Titan, thanks for the raid, sir. Welcome. Welcome to the Titan the Tears. I fucking could have done better, bro. Sorry. Where the fuck's Higgy? Where is he, bro? Get fucking Higgy in here. Where the fuck's Higgy? Fucking blasting the bagpipes, bro. Somebody get me this guy in.
He's on version 1.5. He's just upgrading.
Ah, shit. How long's it going to take?
He's loading in now.
Alright. Fuck's sake. He wasn't even on the right version, bro. He wasn't even on the right fucking version. He was on 1.5, bro. Right. Spade and Jen, dude. So last time we seen old Spadykins went up, I'm looking at, I guarantee you Spadykins will go up again. He'll fucking go up. I want to see Jen dude follow him up. Me, I'm at the top, and let's try and get some fucking pippy pippy pat pat pips at the top of that circle. Good God. This is taking years off my life, guys. Shake, it was posted in ED forums, it was posted in the Facebook DCS Multiplayer Addicts group, it was posted on DCS Multiplayer Addicts in Discord. You've only got yourself to blame, sir. This could have been you, bro. This could have been you. This was... I'm just going to move on, Shake. Alright? I'm just going to move on. Alright, Spadykins goes up. Gen dude is going to follow him up. That's sort of what we predicted. And Jen dude with a bit more nose authority with Spade now. I think Spade's going to play the energy game here. This is, Spade wants this guy to do this. Yep, he's playing the energy game. So Spade seen that he was playing on the same game and Spade unloaded a little bit. Rather than force that nose head on merge. That nose head on merge. That head on nose merge. Here it comes though, here it comes. Spade takes a taste, a little taste. Wants another one. Jen dude doing the right thing, getting that nose down to recover all that energy that he lost. Now he's going to have a good bit of nose authority. Probably doesn't want to spend it all at once here though. Ah, and he does. He likes to spend it all for the shot. I'm not sure if that's a good idea, bro. Well, he's made it work. He has made it work. I'm not going to judge him. I am not going to judge him. Although, bro, what is this? What the fuck is going on here, dude? Spade's coming, bro. Spadykins is coming. Dun-dun. Dun-dun. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Spade doesn't see him! Does Spade see him? Spade does not see him, bro! The general has fucking nailed it! Jen dude has somehow just fucking... just threw the fucking rulebook out the fucking cockpit! Dude, 45 knots at one point, now he's gonna rail him! He didn't shoot, bro! Great flying by Jen dude though. keeps looking like he's making mistakes, but well, to me anyway, but to be honest, the guy's fucking, I think the guy's in the driving seat. Oh, this is a lovely little shot here. Look at this, both aircraft rolling around each other on the way down. This is nice. Ah, Spade moving into the driving seat now. Gendered really slow, less than 300 knots. What's Spade got? Spade's at 350. Spade needs to squat the jet now and get these rounds out. Let's get some shots out, bro. Squat, squat, squat. There we go. Ah, taste. Lovely. Loving it. Spade goes through. 2-0. Good fighting though, Jen, dude. Good fight. I can't believe that fucking stall turn worked out, brother. Good God. Awesome. Awesome. Right, so Spadekins is through. Spadekins. Fuck yeah. Is this him here? Ava. Who the fuck is Ava?
Channel switch.
Who's Ava? Is that Kyle? Is that Higgy?
Yeah, that's Higgy.
Roger.
He's just doing a 20-second warm-up, and then we're going to get it going.
Copy. Good luck, guys.
Channel switched.
All right. As you heard, bros, you heard it out of the horse's mouth. They're just doing a quick warm-up. And then we're going to get the fucking bagpipes back on, bro. Right. Ah, this could be my opportunity just to breathe a little bit. Hawk's through, 2-0. Shit, we didn't even catch any of that. I'm so sorry, Hawk. Sorry, brother. Where is he? So Hawk is through, 2-0. In fact, we did catch that because he was fighting against Hannibal. So, yeah, we'll be seeing the American pilot flying against the Iranian pilot. The Iranian pilot went through, guys. The Iranian bro didn't take him to school, but it was a good. From what we've seen anyway, it was a good fight. Is this it starting? This might be it starting, guys. Here we go. The man, the myth, the legend, Higgy has come amongst us, ladies and gentlemen. Get him, Higgy! This is Scotland versus America, guys. Coyote representing the United States. Higgy representing God's country. Someone is warping like fuck. What's going on here? That's ticked. Alright. Ah, we're gonna have to restart this. Hold on, guys. So who is Challenger through or is Challenger out? Is Challenger through or is Challenger out? Can we get the Iranians that are not in out of the server, please?
Copy.
Thanks.
Channel switched. Channel switched.
You guys are seeing heavy warping, yeah?
Yeah. Just then.
Just restart that, buddy. Restart it. Thanks, man.
Channel switched.
Right. How bad are things on this? Alright, so we're going to restart those two, guys. Unfortunately, I've had to bring down the 104 server just to free up a little bit of bandwidth to make sure that we are providing the best event possible. Here we go with Tolovay and Squirtle. This should be a good one, guys. This should be a really good one. Both very talented pilots. Both electing to go up, which is sort of standard for the high energy fight. They're going to force a one circle at the top here. I think Tolovay's going to get the first rounds out. Shoot! Oh, no! I think both pilots taking a little taste. Oh shit, Tolovay's on fire! And not the good way! So Squirtle is just so fucking accurate with that gun, guys. We've seen him do this time and time again with his head-on shots. Does a great job. It's his very first multiplayer event, my man Squirtle. Oh shit, and Squirtle's hit! They're both hit! What happened? Tolovay was on fire. Pip, 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 pip. Oh. So both aircraft just taking little bites out of each other. F-15 strong though. Ah, oh, that was a nice maneuver, Squirtle. He spent all the energy, bro. Let's make it count. He's so good with his head-on shots. Ah, oh, dude, some great hits. Some great hits, but fucking Tolovey as well, man. Coming back with a head-on shots. Both these pilots did such a good job. I think Squirtle's dead. Squirtle ejected into the fish. God damn it, Squirtle. Squirtle's out of there, right? Fucking come at me. Come on, son. Alright, and the fight's on, guys. The fight is on. Higgy with some 700 knots into the merge. I love this guy. He's doing a really good job at maintaining his energy as well. He's nearly at the top and he's still doing 550 plus. So he's elected not to go for 9G and just sort of kick around about the 5 and 6G mark at the top. We're now at the top of the loop with 450 knots, right on corner speed. So far, so good from the Higmaster. I don't think Coyote sees him. I don't think Coyote even fucking sees him. Oh my god, bro! Oh my god! Freedom! Freedom, bro! I love this. Instantly gets the air breakout, goes for lag pursuit rather than getting too greedy and going for lead. This is great fucking BFM. This might be my new favourite guy. Come on, Higster. He's going to be patient and he's going to roll it over and follow him. Patience, patience, patience. Roll it over, follow him. Love this guy. Love this guy! Come on, bro, let's get fucking Mel Gibson. Higgy takes the first one. Alright, Squirtle and Tolovey back on the head-to-head snatch. Squirtle's going to take a little taste. Get some fucking Squirtle! It's so good with that fucking shot, bro. This guy is so fucking good, man. I love this guy. I may be rooting for Squirtle. I'm a fucking massive Squirtle. Somebody find me a flag. I'm a massive fucking Squirtle fan, guys. If only he was Scottish. If only he was Scottish. Another great shot. I think Tolovey has departed. He's doing the fucking salmon. Just to do anything to try and stay alive. The fish might get him though. Not like this, bro. Not like this. Oh, he saves it. He saves it. And Squirtle was just so accurate with that fucking gun, dude. Come on, Squirty Poos. Put him down. Put him down, son. Ah, bro, this game's up. Game's over. Game over. Have mercy, Squirtle. Shows think of the guy's family, for fuck's sake. And he didn't think of his family. Instead, he shot him in the face. No mercy, guys. No mercy. So Squirtle looks like he might be through. My man Higgy. Right, so Higgy's very fast again, but he's low this time. And Coyote elects to go up. So I think Coyote taking a good lesson out of what happened the last time. He lost sight very early on. And if you know anything about BFM, you know that the saying, lose sight, lose the fight. And that's pretty much exactly what happened to Coyote the last time. Although it doesn't really look like he sees us at the moment. He's not. Oh shit, dude. I think he doesn't see us. I think Higgy fucking sees him though. Somebody get me Mel Gibson on the phone. This guy's a fucking movie star. Does he? What's going on? I don't think Higgy sees him. I don't think they don't see each other, guys. They did not see each other. No way. So it just goes to show you guys, it's so important to keep tabs on your fucking enemy. Lose sight, lose the fight. So let's get on board with Coyote. Come on, Coyote. This is your big chance, sir. He's down there. They don't see each other. Oh my god. Higgy's in a good spotting opportunity though. Higgy doesn't see him. Higgy does not see him. Nighty Poos, thanks for the resub on the tier 1, dude. Thank you very much. Where were you, champ? This could have been you, bro. This could have been all you. Thanks for your support though, bro. Tier 1 for 3 months. Alright, come on, he's fucking right there, bro. Surely you see this guy. Yeah, they see each other now. They see each other now. A coyote with a nice sensible unload here. He wants to fucking roll and pull. Bro, Hickey doesn't see us. Hickey does not see us. He's been blinded. Does Coyote see him? Yeah, Coyote looks like he's hot on his heels. Someone really should have died by now. I'm not trying to talk any shit, alright? Both these guys are doing a great job. But someone should be fucking dead by now, guys. Coyote with a very fucking interesting tactic. I think he definitely sees him. If you look at his pilot head, he's looking straight at him. But Higgy doesn't see him. And Coyote just keeps turning outside him. Fucking kill him, bro. Go, dude, go. More aggression. More aggression, brother. Let's go. And again, just turning outside him. I don't want to judge the guy or tell him that he's doing it wrong, but Higgy's not really giving him too many BFM problems here. He's consistently just sort of, almost turning the exact same way. Coyote needs to get more aggressive and push in there. Start taking advantage of this airspeed and altitude. And he's going to just reset for lag pursuit, which is a sensible thing to do. He's staying right on top of him. I still don't think Higgy sees where we are. Alright, come on, Coyote. This is your big chance, dude. Alright, he's traded all his fucking airspeed now. It's getting close. Oh, please make this count, Coyote. You've been in the driving seat for so long, dude. Higgy definitely sees where we are now, though. Coyote just needs to be patient here. That's a great kill shot. A great kill opportunity coming up here. Higgy might force this overshoot, brothers and sisters. He's going to go for the Mii maneuver. Hits the brakes, and Coyote flies right by. But I think Higgy's lost visual on him. Oh, what a turn. What a turn of fortune. Get him. Oh, unlucky, bro. That would have been fucking beautiful. Both aircraft slow. I think Higgy looks faster. Coyote's down at like the 260 knot regime. What's the Higmaster doing? Higgy's doing 360 knots, so he has. I'd say Higgy's more in the driving seat right now. Look how fucking nose up Coyote is, though. That's a big gamble for how slow he is. Higgy needs to just really start rating round now. That's it, exactly on cue, just does exactly that. Start rating, bro, he's slow. Possible kill shot coming up. Nope. So Higgy still 350 plus. It looks like Coyote's done a good job at recovering some airspeed. Ah, Coyote's still very slow, guys. 230 knots. Come on, Higmaster. This is all you, bro. Freedom. Freedom. Here it comes. Nope. Put the flag back down. Alright, squat the jet, bro. Just fucking spend it all now. Spend it all now. He's going up. Spend it, spend it, spend it. Spend it, bro. Spend that shit. Shoot him. Yes. Get him, bro. Freedom. Yes. He's through. He is through. Fucking win, bro. Win. I am not biased whatsoever. I show no favouritism, guys. This stream is 100% impartial. 100% impartial, guys. No favouritism shown. What else we got? So the Higmaster's through. Fucking hell, bro. Right, so we should have. So Spade got through. So Squirtle and Tolovay, not Tolovage, that's a really bad word. Higgy 1-2-0, thanks for that. What happened with Squirtle actually beat Tolovay. So Squirtle's through, guys. Squirtle is through 2-1 for the Squirtster. Again, if you want to keep up with the scores, click on this link, guys. Alright, so Higgy is now fighting Bullet. God damn it, there's a fucking... Motherfucker, there's a crisis, guys. There's a crisis if ever I saw one. Oh God, that's a fucking... What's the word I'm looking for? What's the words I'm looking for? What is that? A conflict of interest! I think that's maybe what I'm looking for. Right, guys, I need to quickly run to the bathroom. I will be right back. God damn it. Somebody get me Mel Gibson on the phone. Oh no, I've just wrecked my green screen. Trying to sit down in a chair too fast. Come on, green screen, don't fail me now. Alright, I'm back. Luckily there's no action right now. I think they're both just sort of warming up and doing bits and bobs. Oh. Right, what's happening? What are you saying to me? Maverick Hawk has a problem to connect because of ping, because of VPN problem. Roger. He's out then. Pass on my apologies. Ah, oh, Christ, guys. The stress. DVG89, thanks for the follow, sir. Welcome on board. Welcome to the channel. V-Rakan, thanks for the follow, sir. V-Rakan number one. V-Rakan number one, thanks for the follow. Darren Smith, 456, welcome on board, sir. A Roofed Hobo wins the award for the best stream name so far. Welcome to the channel, sir. Thank you for the follow. Great, see you on the stream, Tolovay. Good to see you, sir. Good to see you. Great flying, my friend. Great flying. Hey, for someone that usually flies fucking Russian jets, bro, you've done a great job, dude. You've done a great job. Really enjoyed watching you fly, sir, and do your business. Well done. Yes, let's go. Come at me. Right, unfortunately, it looks like one of our Iranian brothers is not going to be able to finish the fight because he's having problems connecting. Unfortunately, the internet in Iran is not as great as the people from Iran, so yeah, unfortunately some internet issues there coming out of the Middle East. Right, so we're just getting the next, so this is going to be Bullet versus my man Higgy. What a conflict, guys. What a conflict. Alright, we'll go on board with Higgy for the first one. But if I'm honest, guys, I'm not sure who I'm rooting for. I'm not sure who I want to win this one. Ah, what a conflict. What a conflict of interest here. Alright, Higgy with the air brake out for unknown reasons. I'm sure he's got a system. Alright, it looks like Higgy wants to squat the jet really early for some... He wants to stay inside Bullet's turn circle and get some shots out early to put Bullet under pressure. I'm anticipating the Bullet's going to be fast and he's going to go up. Looks fast. Doesn't really go up. Both pilots sort of electing to turn and burn. In the horizontal. Both pilots going for the old Timmy 2 circle here. We still got the air brake out. No, air brake's back in. Oh, Bullet with a fucking early hit on him. Took an early taste out the Higgster. Ah, great out of plane manoeuvre there from Higgy to get out of the danger zone. That was awesome. Really liked that. But Bullet is no slouch, unfortunately, dude. And if you don't look after that energy, he's going to make you pay for it. Bullet's a fantastic high energy fighter. Higgy's doing a good job of just good nose authority here to stay out of the danger zone. But it's going to start costing him now because he doesn't really have anywhere else to go. He is going to have to start fighting him in the turn very soon because it doesn't fly very well under the water, the F-15. He's very slow. He's down like 200 knots. Bullet is in the 400 knot regime, so Bullet can actually afford to start squatting the jet right now. Start moving that nose. And it looks like that's what he's doing. Spending. And in turn, Higgy's just going to keep pulling. He's going to get even slower. Bullet electing to just unload a little bit, recover some energy. I think the Higgster's trying to do the same. Breakaway, thanks for the follow, sir. Welcome on board. Alright, squat that jet, Bullet, and shoot him. That's going to force Higgy even slower. So Bullet elects to instead... He unloaded for a little second, now he's back up at about 6G, 5G. In a good driving position now, though. Higgy with a very, very risky, slow energy manoeuvre. I don't think this is going to end very well for him. Bullet takes another little taste. Oh my god! The Higgster! What a fucking roll in reversal, bro! Oh my god, he's going to shoot him! Beautiful BFM by Higgy. Oh, look at this dude. Holy shit, son. Bullet's made a fucking cataclysmic error. But so is the Higmaster. And the Higmaster is food for the fish. God damn it. Unlucky, sir. Well flown. Fucking beautiful maneuver there, bro, for the roll reversal. I love that shit. Unfortunately, it didn't quite go too well after that, though. Yeah, Breakaway 83, thank you for the follow, sir. There's so many difficult names on the stream today, guys. Fooferlol. Hopefully I've said that right. I hate pronouncing people's names wrong. Welcome to the channel, my friend. Thank you for your support. This one. Right, so we're just waiting to see. So what was that? Is that 2-0? No, that's 1 each. That is 1 each, I think, guys. No, it's not. That's 1-0 to Bullet. Is it? Fucking hell. Alright, so this is
Channel switch.
This is round 2, guys, yeah?
Yeah, firm, round 2.
Copy, good luck.
Channel switch.
Alright, round 2, guys. Round 2. The Higmaster General versus the Stone Cold Bullet. Come at me. Right, we're right on board with Bullet this time. I think Bullet's going to go up this time because it really worked out for him before in previous fights. And when he didn't go up in that last fight, when he elected to turn with him instead, he almost got fucking shot, bro. So I think Bullet is going to go for the one circle, the shot at the top. But either way, I prophesize that Bullet's going up. What have we got? Both aircraft going up. Yep, they both want a little taste at the top. The bullet's going to stay with it. He wants that nose of 40. Higgy should unload here, which is what he's done. Good lad. He's unloaded and he's like, bro, you want to spend all that energy? Be my guest. Some great BFM by Higgy today, guys. For a guy that fucking came into the tournament thinking it was 1.5. Bro, we're on 2.5.6. This kid showed up with 1.5 installed. Oh, Higgy, no. Don't let this happen, dude. Oh, no. Bullet with a fucking yellow rice. The yellow rice from God, bro. Oh, my God. No, Higgster. No! You fucking leave him alone, Bullet. Oh, let me see the shot. Oh, he's going to run him out of energy. Bullet's going to fucking... Oh, will Higgy shoot him in the face, dude? This will be such a... Almost. Almost got it. Dude, I thought Higgy was just going to blast him in the face there, man. That would have been epic. Absolutely epic. Higgy doing a great job of staying out of plane. Bullet's trying to move for a second. You see that little jink to the left just to try and go heavy on the lag pursuit. Bullet firmly in the driving position. Both aircraft struggling below 200 knots now. The first guy to kind of roll upside down is going to be the first one to recover energy, but he's going to get shot trying to do it, so they're both trying to fucking go up. We're at nearly 15,000 feet doing 140 knots. Bullet tries to go for the pirouette, it doesn't work out, and Higgy's right in the driving seat now! Oh, Higgy turns it right round, bro! The Higgster! This guy came out of fucking nowhere, dude. Bullet is going down, bro. Good God. Higgy from fucking nowhere. You're not recovering that shit, sir. God damn, one apiece, guys. One apiece. Alright, so it's one each. Scores. Higgy one, Bullet one. Submit scores. So again, if you're just joining us, guys, here is the table that we're working from. The wizard says take out pistols. That would have been a good call, sir. That could have been a good call. Just eject the canopy and fucking start popping at him. Right, here we go, guys. The pressure's on. Fucking pressure's on. Two of my favourite guys. The Higmaster from Scotland and 104th Bullet from America. Who's it going to be? We'll go on board with the Higmaster General. So let's see what he does. I think both pilots are going to go up again. Kenny worked out. They put each other in better geometry last time, so Kenny think both pilots are going to go for it again. I think he loves that air brake.
Connected. Channel switched. Sound muted.
Alright, here we go. Alright, Higgy electing to stay in the horizontal, Bullet elects to go up. Higgy's looked after his airspeed very well though, so he has the beans to get out of the way. Oh, Bullet, this is a dangerous place for Higgy. Really dangerous. The problem here is you have to maneuver so violently to get out of plane. And if the other guy's good like Bullet is, he's just going to be able to follow you right round, so... Bullet getting maybe a little bit desperate and trying to... Holy fuck! Higgy with a me maneuver forces the overshoot! Bullet's in big trouble! I don't think Higgy has the nose authority to get a shot though. Oh my god, bro, he might. Bullet has to be fucking sweating now. The Higmaster's doing 70 knots. Both aircraft look like they've almost departed. Bullet needs to try and recover that as fast as possible. Higgy's doing some very sensible, heavy nose down. Needs to roll left, Higgy. What's Bullet doing? Is Bullet dead? Bullet might be dead, guys. Bullet's dead! Bullet is fucking dead! Bullet's out! Holy shit, the Higmaster General takes it 2-1, god damn it! Out of fucking nowhere! You're Squirtle and Spade. Squirtle firmly in the driving seat, putting old Spadekins on the defensive, but shout out to the Higmaster! Representing Scotland! What a guy! What a fucking guy! Alright, Squirtle we know is a fucking great shot. He's going to try and just squat the jet now and get some rounds on, but Spade's no fucking slouch. He's going to see that coming and he's going to leave the fight and go up. Spade looks like he's got like 450 knots or something. 450 knots! God damn, I'm good at doing that. So Spade nailing corner speed. Squirtle is really slow. He's trying to recover those. Squirtle's getting up above 400. But Spade needs to maybe use it or lose it now. Squirtle's getting real slow because he's trying to rate him round. I don't think you're going to be able to do that with a guy like Spade. He's just going to energy fight you. So both pilots sort of caught in a bit of a stalemate right now. Squirtle around about 400, Spade at around about, sorry that's Squirtle again, Spade again, corner, 450-ish. I think he's just waiting for him to make a mistake. A very neutral geometry, we've been sort of staring at the same parts of each plane for the same, for sorry, quite an amount of time, so. Good energy discipline by Spade though, hasn't really let the jet get below 430. Squirtle elects to start a high-low yo-yo to see if that can kind of help him out, but I think this is what Spade's been waiting for. Squat right now and shoot, bro. Ah, dude, I would have fucking just binned that in my stomach and shot at him there, but hey, Spade knows what he's doing, I'm not judging him. I just think that was a missed opportunity, that's all. Well, it's working out for him now though, Spade follows him on the high-low yo-yo just to neutralise that. And again, dude, I'm thinking just squat here, bro. Squat that fucking jet and start shooting stuff at him. I think this is a great shooting position, but Spade elects to just be disciplined and go with patience. Wait for Squirtle to make a mistake. And because it's working for Spade. Spade's just sort of reeling him in. Just fucking reeling him in, bro. Taking his time. Just fucking, hey. Just you stay out there, bro. I'm going to just not panic. A risky as fuck reversal. So when we talk about just being patient and waiting for the other pilot to make a mistake, that's exactly what Spade would have been waiting on. And a great shot by Spade. Great shot. Looks like that's a good centre mass shot from Spade. Almost pulls a fucking cobra. And that looks like that's 1-0 to old Spadekins. Good old Spadekins. Right, so let's update the scores. Higgy got through. Mark is in progress. Report scores. Higgy won 2-1. So Higgy is in the semi-final and he's going to be fighting, in fact Havel's through because our Iranian friend unfortunately lost connection. So the semi-finals, this is round one of the semi-final, guys. Spade versus Squirtle. Round two is going to be Havco versus Higgy, Russia versus Scotland. Totally impartial. Alright, let's get on board with old Squirtle. I love this guy. This is this guy's very first ever multiplayer PvP event. Made it to the fucking semi-finals. What a guy. What a guy. Somebody get me some fucking Squirtle t-shirts made up. Bring me a coffee, says Gromit. I can't leave my seat. I know the feeling, bro. I know the feeling, dude. My coffee is so low, dude. It's so low. I've just got a little piddly pap in the bottom there. It's a sad state of affairs in there, sir. Right. Let's go, Squirtle. Let's go, Squirtle. What you got? So both pilots electing to go up. This is where we know Squirtle's very good. I think Spade's going to get out of it now. Spade's going to unload. Let Squirtle do his thing. And that's exactly what he does. Squirtle's going to try and be a bit greedy and follow him around. That's exactly what Spade wants him to do. Look how much energy Squirtle's hemorrhaging right now. Spade's still going to be at like 450 plus. 420. Oh, sorry, this is fucking... Oh, there's Spade there. 420. The other semi-final's underway right now. In fact, guys, hold on 1 second. Hold on. Channel guys, can you both go back to spectators? Because this is a semi-final. We're going to watch it after Spade's match.
Roger, was out.
Channel switched.
I will show you the semi-finals one at a time, guys. So this is semi-final number one. Spade versus Squirtle. Squirtle looks like he's in the driving seat right now, however. He is slow. Spade's very fast and has the energy advantage. Squirtle has the angles, and we know that Squirtle's very good with these shots. Spade getting a little bit wobbly. A little bit of a salmon on. And again, look how much nose down Squirtle takes. Spade just trying to scare him a little bit, just trying to force him to do something there with those shots. But Squirtle is very happy with staying slow and staying inside the guy's turn circle. Squirtle's not really too much of an energy fighter from what I can see, which is fine. That's how the F-18 fights. F-18's not really an energy fighter. It's more of an inside the circle fighter. Is Squirtle blacked out? No, he's just unloaded for Smash here. But Spade's a very good energy fighter. The difficulty is that Squirtle's very good in this position where he's low on energy, but has the nose authority to stay inside the circle and get the rounds off. So he hit him. He fucking definitely hit him there. Squirtle took a little taste out, so Spade's in trouble. Spade is very much in trouble, guys. Squirtle is slow as shit, but he's making it work. And again, just pippy, pat, pat, pip. Just pressure. Just little bits of pressure coming out. Spades. Oh, great shooting. Great shooting, Squirtle. Squirtle takes it. What a guy. What a guy. I love this guy. Alright, somebody come at me with the scores.
Channel
switched. What's the scores, guys? Is that one each?
1-1.
One each.
1-1, Roger. Good luck.
Channel switched.
Alright, 1-1, guys. It all comes down. It's all coming down again. 104 Spadykins. An absolute fucking veteran of the not only the PvP community, but just DCS in general. This guy's been flying for longer than I have. An absolute veteran versus a total fucking newcomer. This guy's very first PvP event and multiplayer that he's ever taken part in. He's fighting against one of the strongest F-15 pilots in the entire game. And he's doing real well. On paper, he's not flying to the F-15 strengths, but good fucking God, is he making it work, guys. But we're right on board with Spadykins. Thanks for the bits. Who was it? My man Bullet. Thanks for the bits. Well flown, Bullet. Well flown. Unfortunately, the power of Scotland's got you, bro. No one's judging you for that, dude. No one's judging you for that. Alright, Spade with a good bit of energy. Looks like Squirtle's matching him this time. Maybe he's getting wise to it, and he is. You just seen that little unload from Squirtle there. I think he's maybe going to try and be greedy again and just try and put us under pressure. Maybe I'd like to see a little bit more lag pursuit here rather than this sort of geometry, but okay, I don't want to judge him too much. He's whatever this guy is doing, it's fucking working. Good old Squirtle. Alright, here's a good snapshot opportunity for Spade. He's going to actually elect to get out of it. I think he's identified just how talented Squirtle is in these head-on shots. The guy's deadly fucking accurate. So Spade electing to rather than force the issue and random number generator, take a gamble, he just got out of there. This is dangerous for Spade. Really dangerous, bro. Oh my god! Squirtle, ladies and gentlemen. An absolute fucking monster with this F-15. Spade is... Oh my god, Spade's firing back up. Now, the F-15's strong. She's not that... doesn't seem to give a fuck, bro. Alright, cue all the F-15 haters in the chat. I mean, technically, the body is a lifting surface, guys. But this is... this is a bit of a meme. Nah, Spade's going down. There's no way he's going to be able to recover from that. He is. He is out of there, unfortunately. Poor Spadekins. And here comes the Squirt Master. Fucking hell, bro. He's still turning with it. Holy shit. Ah, bro. Ah, there he goes. He hit the water. He hit the water, dude. So my man Squirtle makes it through. Holy fuck, guys. Alright, let's update the scores. So Squirtle takes it. Squirtle is in the final. So now we have... So that was 1 to Spade, 2 to Squirtle. Now, to give Spade his dues, Spade only knew that he was flying this event about an hour ago. We needed some more pilots, so I was like, Spade, can you fly? He's like, I don't have any practice. I'm like, yeah, fuck it, bro, just get in. So I'm not trying to take anything away from Squirtle. Squirtle done a fucking great job, but just total disclosure, guys, I sort of ambushed Spade with this, and he sort of got thrown in the deep end right there. Right, so Squirtle's through. So now we have the man, the myth, the legend, Higgy. Going to be taking on our Russian brother, Havko. From parts unknown. We just know that he's from Russia. So we got Scotland versus Moscow. Well, probably Moscow. Fucking Iron Brew versus Vodka coming up here, guys.
There's no iron brew, brother. How the hell have you not got the iron brew, lads? No iron brew. Are you crazy? I swear to God, I'm crazy. How the no iron brew? How you got no iron brew, lads? No iron brew.
All right, let's get back in the action. I think they actually just might be warming up. Could have went with Iron Brew meme for a little bit longer. They're just sort of warming up, guys. Shaking off that rust. Just flexing. Flexing. So again, if you're just joining us, guys, here is the scores so far. So we got Higgy on the right, flying as Ava for some reason. And we have Havko representing Russia on the left. This is going to be a good one. Champ. Champ Pharos. Hopefully I've said that right, bro. Thanks for the follow, sir. Welcome to the channel. Disfad Bidge. Thanks for the follow. Skiddy Plays. Thanks for the follow. Welcome, guys. Welcome to the channel. Well, we'll go in with a Higmaster first. And in the next round, we'll go in with our Russian friend, Havko. So I think Higgy's got the air brake out and he's burning just to try and get the weight on the aircraft down a little bit, maybe. Doesn't want to go too fast. Wants to stay around about corner speed if he can. Brings the air brake in for the merge. Both aircraft merging at 5,000 feet. Not too much vertical action. Definitely Higgy taking it more upstairs though. It looks like Havco's got the angles at the moment. He does look very slow. He may be trying the squirtle maneuver. Just wants to squat the jet and get rounds out, but it looks like he's backed off though. Higgy doing a good job at holding on to his energy. Takes the fight back up again so he can reset. Havco very fucking slow. 240 knots. This is dangerous, dude. This is real dangerous. This is too slow to get any nose authority. Especially with Higgy playing the safe game, staying upstairs. Higgy needs to start making hay now. He needs to come down and start really bullying this guy and pushing him around. Although Higgy's got down to 200 knots. So obviously comfortable playing a slow game as well as a high energy game. Trying to keep the nose below the horizon as much as possible so he doesn't hemorrhage too much. This looks like it could work out if he just can roll around. I think Higgy definitely in the driving seat first. He is going to run out of altitude pretty soon though. Both pilots are now at the point where they've ran out of energy and we're in this sort of neutral turn fight. Both pilots trying to recover back to corner as fast as they can. Higgy's a little bit slower. It looks like our man Havco's... they're actually matching each other pretty well for speed right now. Higgy seems to be rating just a little bit. Now, is he going to get greedy here? Havco looks like he spent an awful lot of energy. Higgy's going to take it upstairs. Roll back over and come down in the high yo-yo. This looks like this could work out. I think Havco might have identified what's going on. And Alex to try and do the same thing and stay in close. Oh, and Higgy with a very, very risky stall turn maneuver. Perfectly timed, though, because Havco is very slow. So, certainly high risk, but it... He who dares wins, and it looks like Higgy is daring. Is he going to have enough altitude to recover? Yes, he is. We're down below 200 knots again, and our Russian friend is now in the driving seat. Almost developing into a rolling scissors here. Both pilots just barrel rolling around each other. Higgy just with a little bit of rudder to the left, just to try and go for lag pursuit here. Trying to get into that lag pursuit course. Alright, yeah, nose down below the horizon just to get that nose moving. It looks Havco's going to recover with some good energy at the bottom of this this rollout here. Higgy around about 350 knots. Maybe getting tempted, thinking about squatting the jet and getting some shots out, but looks like he's electing to show more discipline. Both pilots matching each other for airspeed here again. 350 knots around about that across the board. Nice neutral geometry. So this could potentially come down to fuel, guys. This could be the first one we see coming down to fuel. Higgy just sort of loading and unloading, loading and unloading. He's up above 400 knots now. Havco's about 50 knots behind him. So again, this is going to come down to either which pilot loses patience or which pilot makes a mistake first. Havco's identified that he is losing the rate fight here. Higgy's getting angles and he's not being too greedy with it. That's the problem for Havco, is that Higgy is not trying to turn inside a circle. He's being patient and trying to hold that lag pursuit course. See, just see that little unload for Higgy, the jet at the back there, just to stay in the back seat. Havco at 360 knots now. Higgy looks a little faster. Higgy's actually a lot slower, so he has elected to start squatting. This is where we talk about where someone's going to lose patience or make a mistake. Havco with a very good unload and go manoeuvre. Puts a little bit of separation, but then elects to start turning in. Higgy's going to start trying to follow him around. And we're taking the fight back up into the vertical now. Well, this could be a good kill-off shot. Oh, beautiful, dude. Beautiful. Havco's in big trouble. Big trouble. It's not over, though. Oh, no. Higgy needs to be careful when he identifies the danger straight away. Gets out of that fucking plane. And just make sure it doesn't happen. Nice little roll to the left now, kid, to slick in behind him. Good job, son. I like this guy. Kid came out of fucking nowhere, bro. Rolled up with 1.5 installed. Wasn't even on 2.5. Rolled up with 1.5. Alright, I was going to say, just back off, dude. Back off. Yeah, maybe should have backed off there, went for lag pursuit, but hey, it's the guy's leaking fuel. Higgy's still very much in the driving seat, but we've seen this frown get turned upside down before. We have seen the damaged jet come round and take a big fucking chunk out of the undamaged jet, so Higgy needs to go up. Go up, bro. Up, 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 up. Good lad. Perfectly timed as well. Good man. Oh, bro, people are running out of fuel. Oh, no, I think he's just shutting his... Avco is out. Yep, one engine. And he bends it. So the Higmaster. What a guy. What a guy. Alright, 1-0 to the Higmaster. Right, let's get on board with Havco, representing Mother Russia. Let's get you guys on board. Good God, I gotta pee. Splish, splash, I was taking a bath. He was indeed, dude, he was indeed. But it was a great flight, but great flight. A great fight by both pilots. Really enjoyed watching that one. That was a good one. All right, here we go. Here we go. It's the bottom of the ninth. If Higgy wins this, he goes through. If Havco wins, we get one more round. So no one goes up. Havco looks like he wants inside that circle. And he wants to take the early gamble on the shots. Oh, this is a horrible position, bro. Oh, dude, watch the water. Yeah. Alright, Higgy looks like he's allowed himself to get really slow. Both jets below 300 by the looks of it. Yes, fucking, the Higmaster's doing 150 knots at one point. He's in big fucking trouble, dude. Watch out, man. The Russians are coming. Oh, bro, you're out of there. You are out of there. Havco takes it back. Get some Putin power on the board. Takes it back. Great fight. Great fight. Alright, right, so it's one apiece. One apiece. Next one. So this is the semi-final, guys. The winner of this round goes through to the final. And it looks like he's going to be fighting Squirtle. In fact, actually, so after this round, guys, we're going to have the... We're going to have Spade fighting whoever loses this round to see who comes in third place. All right, both pilots back in. Let's get in it to win it. Good God, I have to pee. The excitement's way too much for me, fam. Alright, Hick, we've seen this is pretty much a standard setup for the Hickmaster. Air brake's going to come in about now. There it is. There he goes. Alright, who's going to go for it? Who's going to go for it? It looks like Havco is going to go for the shot. Hick, he's going to try and save some energy and go up. Maybe spent a little bit too much. Bit of a risky reversal here. He's going to go nose down and see if he, just for maximum G, just to get out of the way and make the shot as hard as possible. Halfco takes a good taste. A real good taste. Both pilots very, very slow, trying to force each other in front. Halfco doing a good job at identifying. That's what Higgy's trying to do. Oh, bro, that was close. That was close. Look at Higster though, just fucking nose up, bro. Just go past me, bro. Go past me. 100 knots, both pilots below 100 knots. Oh, this would be beautiful if this works out. I don't have enough AOA. Havco electing to do this. Oh, God, I was going to say the sensible thing and get that nose down, but Higgy is just rating up, following him right round. The Higmaster might get him here. I don't think he has the nose of 40. Oh, Havco, if you'd went up, bro. Mind you, doesn't really have the energy to do that. And Higgy takes a taste. Havco, recover, recover. Recover, bro. No. He does recover. He does recover. He's in bad fucking shape, though. Real bad shape. Higgy just needs to keep pappy, pippy, pap, pap, pip. Keep him under pressure, bro. Maybe went pure pursuit a little bit too early there. I think... Havco's damaging the jet by loading the G up. Bits are falling off and down he goes, bro. The Higster makes it to the finals, guys. We have Squirtle taking on Higgy in the finals. Good God.
Channel switched.
All right, can we have Spade and Spade and Havco for the third place?
Okay.
So we're going to do Spade and Havco for third place, and then we'll do the final, Squirtle and Higster.
All right.
I'll be back in a minute.
Channel switched.
All right, stream. I'll be right back. I'm going to pee myself if I don't go now. I'll be right back. Too much excitement, bro. God damn it.
Channel switched.
All right, come at me.
Channel switched.
Hey, Mick. Thank you very much, dude. Thanks for the re-up, brother. What are we talking here? Resub on the prime time for 8 months. Good God, sir. Thank you very much. Confirmed cocaine and prostitutes for Maverick next month. It's my birthday next month as well. All right, so we have Spade and Havco fighting for third place coming up, guys. Yeah, really, good to see you, sir. Good to see you. Yeah, so the guy whose very first tournament ever gets to the finals. The guy that fucking rolled up with 1.5 installed also gets to the finals. You couldn't make this shit up. You could not make this shit up, guys. What's the fucking hold up here?
Channel switch. Take the slots and get ready.
Channel switch.
Oh, they're just getting started. Let's get you guys on board. Boom. Boom. I am an Aries, but all that shit's bollocks, Tolovey. That doesn't fucking mean anything, bro. But yes, my friend, I am an Aries. Havoc! Ah, bro, I think you need to work on your hearing. How fucking dare you, sir? How dare you question me? Alright, Spadekins with a G warm-up. My man Havco. My man Havco electing not to do the G warm-up. Instead, he just wants to YOLO straight in. Hey, I'm not judging you, bro. I am not judging you. We might see a very aggressive turn from Spade at the merch here, guys. Spade might be trying to get this done early. Let's get on board and check him out. Alright, where's our Russian friend? There he is there. There's this goddamn buster. Let's take him down. Alright, Spade does elect to go up, but he's spending it. He's spending it. Yep, spending it. No, actually, he's let go. He's only doing 4G. So Spade wants to be fast and stay fast. That's A-OK with me, brother. Havco very slow down at the bottom, though. He's going to start recovering some of that now. Havco, I think, wants to take some shots inside the circle. Doesn't have the nose authority to make it count, though. And he might get a little bit greedy here and really start pulling for lead pursuit when really he really should be working on lag pursuit right now, but he is going to be greedy. This might pay off for him, though. I'm not judging the guy. Here comes a shot. Spade manages to get out of the way. He sees that shit coming. But yeah, Havco getting very slow. Electing to just stay inside this circle. Oh, and he gets a hit. He does get a hit. So the gamble fucking paid off. Hits him again. Spade's in big trouble. Big trouble. Very difficult to get out of this position. Very, very difficult. Especially with a damaged aircraft. You really just have to start rolling back and forward in scissors. Hope for the fucking best, dude. Ah, great shot, dude. Great shot by Russian bro. 1-0 to Mr. Russia. If you haven't done so already, guys, make sure you check out the event sponsor, Wild Weasel Apparel. If you fly DCS, I guarantee you there's something on that website that you want to buy. All your favourite military aircraft from real life and DCS. There's loads of stuff in that store. It's hoodies, t-shirts for men, t-shirts for ladies, hats, mouse mats, cups. Loads of stuff. We even have a 104 fucking squadron t-shirt in there, bro. God damn it. Gonna be getting some Maverick merch. Gonna be getting some Maverick. I want a fucking t-shirt that says God fucking damn it on it. That's what I want. Alright, both pilots back in the pit. And again, Spadekin's electing to get that G warm-up under go. Havco's just gonna YOLO straight in. It paid off for him last time. Let's see if we can do it two in a row. So we're on board with the Havmaster. Alright, Havco elects to go up this time and Spade goes down. Some Johnny New Tax. Both pilots look firmly sorted on each other. I'd say Havco's in the driving seat right now. Again, looks like he's very happy just to stay in the circle though. Here we go with a head-on pass. Spade just thinks, fuck that, bro. This guy's throwing the kitchen sink at me. I'm just going to roll out the wave. Great call, Spade. Havco has the nose authority to get the snapshot done, though. It's a risky move for Spade. Spade! I was going to say fucks him in the face, but that's not appropriate. Spade shoots him right in the face. Havco's still in it, though. The pilot is still alive. He's got a good opportunity here. Spade's going to go down. And not in a good way. What?! I don't know if maybe Spade's jet had a bit of damage there and then he pulled and then some aircraft. But that, bro, those shots didn't look like they went any fucking near that to me. What the fuck? No idea what happened there. I know that Havco won. Congratulations to that guy. Right, so it looks like Havco comes in third place. Congratulations to Havco. He'll be able to pick his t-shirt of choice, his weapon of choice from the Wild Weasel store. Congratulations to that dude. Well flown, sir. Well flown.
Channel switched.
Alright, let's go with the final. Come at me.
Channel switched.
Hannibal says, hashtag sloppy guns, name of that guy. Ah, bro, you gotta do what works. You gotta do what works. And the reason why he was railing on for so long and that sort of first head on is just, you might get lucky, bro. You might get lucky. You might get lucky. And ultimately, it did end up paying for him. I think he must have got a hit on Spade and the aircraft took a bit of damage and then Spade put some heavy G on the jet and it fractured the wing structure because that, that little burst that we've seen didn't really, certainly from where we were looking from, I mean, it might be some desync or something like that, but certainly from our perspective, didn't look like it went anywhere near him, bro. Oh, holy shit, I am tired. I am running out of beans, guys. Running out of beans. I still got to go to work after this. Fuck's sake. Right, so, the final. It's the final countdown, guys. We have Higgy taking on Squirtle for first place. Fight is on, guys. Both aircraft merging at 5,000 feet. Both fast. What are we going to do? It looks like Squirtle's going to go up. The Squirtle is so good at squatting the jet, staying inside the turn circle, and getting those head-on shots, which is what I want to see from him here. Play to your strengths, brother. Higgy needs to be very careful with this guy. So Squirtle's slow, but he's not that slow. Higgy looks like he's done a good job playing the energy game. Keeps the nose down. Looks like he's getting very slow now, though. But again, Squirtle is so good at staying inside that turn circle. Very disciplined little check there just to go for lag pursuit. And again, Squirtle with his fucking guns, bro. This guy! I want some fucking hack checks on this guy. This guy's so good. There's another taste. There's another taste. It looks like the writing's on the wall for the Higmaster. Ah, bro, you're not recovering that. She has departed. Mayday, mayday. Higgy's heading out to sea. He's in a flat spin. Well done, Squirtle. This guy. This is the guy. This is his very first multiplayer competition, guys. The first ever. God fucking damn it. All right, fights on, fights on. If Squirtle takes this, he is crowned the Golden Eagle. If Higgy takes it, we're down to another round. Looks like they're both going up for the one circle. Both pilots going to try and get greedy with a head-on shot. They both want it. Higgy looks like he wants to try and get out of the way, though. That's a sensible thing. Now Squirtle's in a dangerous position where if he pulls too hard, he's going to get really low and slow. But Higgy... I thought Higgy came out of the afterburner there. It's just a load, though. It's just a loading thing. But Higgy maintains the energy and wants to go up. Maybe trying to... I think Squirtle's identified that that's what he wants him to do. Squirtle, Higgy wants him to follow him up and lose all his energy, but Squirtle took a quick check, unloaded and flew straight and level to the cover. This is a great shooting position for Squirtle. He's so accurate with this gun, bro. Struggling though, 89 knots, 85, 84, really struggling. The Higmaster in the driving seat. Higgy needs to recover this airspeed and get into lag pursuit. Let's make hay while the sun is shining, brother. Down he comes. Squirtle sees the danger, sees his energy is recovering. Sorry, his opponent's recovering quite a bit of energy. Alexi just goes straight into the vertical pretty much and just get as much cash in the bank as he can. Higgy needs to not be too greedy with lead pursuit here, and he's doing a good job. Don't be too greedy, bro. Lag pursuit, champ. Lag pursuit. He elects to be a bit too greedy. Hope this isn't going to cost him. Oh, he takes a taste. He takes a big taste. Yes! Good. I mean, great flying. A total impartiality, guys. Total impartiality. He was greedy, and he made it pay. Nice. We're going to round three, guys. Round three. Holy shit. This is... the final countdown, guys. The final countdown. The final We're all about partiality here, guys. One of the most non-biased streamers you'll ever see, guys. I have absolutely no favourites or who I want to win. Here we go, we're on board with the Higmaster. He elects to go up. Let's see what Squirtle can do. Squirtle looks fast. It looks like Higgy's a bit more hungry for it though. He's spending a bit more. He's rating him in. Squirtle might unload and go up now. I think they're actually going to go for it. Risky business. Risky business. Who's the top gun? Who can triumph with the days of thunder and make it rain, man? I want to see a few good men. All right, Higgy at the top, but he's slow. Now, is he going to use Squirtle's tactic against him? Is he going to turn inside the circle? No, he's not. He's going to come back and try and recover energy. Squirtle doing a great job at matching him in the energy fight, taking it upstairs. The Hickster has recovered a good bit of energy though. He's 30 knots off the corner speed, bleeding a little bit now though. And I think the Squirtster has lost vis. I think the Higmaster's lost visual as well. God damn it, bro. Oh, this is a big chance for Squirtle here. Big chance the Squirtle can get eyes on. I don't think Higgy sees him. Higgy does not see us, guys. Ah, fuck, we don't see Higgy. God damn it. Oh, he might do now. Higgy's in trouble, guys. Higgy is in trouble. I mean, it's not like I want to see him win. I don't have any favourite in this fight, guys. Oh, for fuck's sake, Squirtle doesn't see him. Oh, bro, I can't watch. I cannot watch. Squirtle doing a great job. Not being too greedy. I don't think fucking... Higgy has no idea where we are, bro. Squirtle doing a good... Look at his air brakes out. This is great flying by Squirtle. Very well disciplined. Higgy lost sight, bro. It's going to cost him. It's going to cost him. He's desperation. Jinking. Bobbing, weaving. Not like this, bro. Not like this. He stays out of the fish. Stays away from the fish. What a shot by Squirtle. What a shot, dude. Is he going to take it? Higgy's in trouble. Higgy's in big trouble. He's still in it, though. He's still... Stranger things have happened, bro. He might force this overshoot, dude. But look at Squirtle. Squirtle's already got the breakout. Did you guys fucking see that? I mean, that's a little bit of network desync, guys. That's just a bit of desync. That's all I want. That didn't really happen. He didn't really go through the water. Calm down. Fucking calm down, guys. That's just a bit of network desync. Look at these two pilots, guys. Look at them. Holy shit. Where's the Higmaster? Oh, dude, he's doing such a good job of staying in a fight, but the writing's on the wall. The writing is on the wall. Here comes Squirtle. He's going to bring the pain, bro. Surely the Higmaster's not going to get away from this. Oh, that's another taste. That's over, bro. It's over. God damn it. That's a draw! That's a fucking draw, guys! That's a draw! It's a tie! It goes fucking round again, guys! It goes round! He's back in it, ladies and gentlemen! He's back fucking in it! Alright, here we go, guys. This is it. This really is it. Oh my god. What a fucking fight, guys. What a fight. All joking aside, I genuinely wish both pilots the best of luck here. Squirtle seems like a fucking great guy. I love this guy. I'm a massive Squirtle fan, guys. but out of fucking nowhere, the Higgster. Alright, no head-on shots in the one circle. Squirtle goes down, Higmaster goes up. Just needs to be patient here. Be patient, kid, that's it. Maybe we'd have given away too many angles if he tried to force a shot there again. You've got to be so careful with a Squirtle guy, he's so good. Even at the head-on shots, he's really fucking dangerous. The Hignus is in a great shot. Please don't fucking lose sight on him this time, Higgy. We need Squirtle to keep good eyes on as well, so we got a good fight. Oh, Higgy's in a good kill position here. This is good, this is good. He needs to not be too greedy. Squirtle doing a fantastic job of just staying out of trouble. Anytime that Higgy's nose come anywhere near him, to get into that sort of kill envelope, Squirtle's just whoop straight out of there. He's doing a fucking great job. Some great flying by both these guys. This is dangerous. This is dangerous for Squirtle. Very dangerous. Squirtle's taking him into the sun. Sneaky mofo takes him straight into the sun. Higgy's really going to struggle to see him. It's not impossible to see him though. Remember, he's got a radar lock on him at this point. Here comes the shots. Here comes the shots. Oh, he's taking him, bro. He's taking him down. Is he going to recover the... No, he's not. Higgy's done it, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my God. The fucking kid from Glasgow from fucking nowhere, bro. Rolled up with 1.5 installed. What a guy.
Oh, Florida, Scotland, when will we see your like again?
We'll never see that again.
That fought and died for.
What a guy. What a fucking guy. Holy shit, guys. What a fucking fight. God damn. Well, let's get them both in here.
User was moved to your channel. User was moved.
Holy shit, guys. Was that as good to fly in as it was to watch?
Oh man, it was tough.
Fucking great flying by both of you guys. Couldn't believe that second round, dude, bro. Listen, Squirtle, man, your shooting was on point, sir. You done a great job. All your shots were bang on point. But I got to say, man, fucking, I think Higgy just had the luck of the Irish on him, even though he's Scottish, because that, you had that, bro. You it was all you. And then I was just saying on the stream, like, you never give up, never give up. And then unfortunately, that mid-air collision reset it again. But good God. Good God. Yeah. Talk to us, Higgy. What was your strategy going in there, brother?
Don't panic.
Just don't panic and try and make good decisions.
Well, I was tight a few times, so I just kept saying, when I was going to be defensive, no matter what I done, so I just kept saying, calm. So if you go for a shot, you're going to overshoot unless you go lag.
We did see that. Squirtle, we noticed that you... I'm not saying you're a bad energy fighter, bro. That's not what I'm saying, all right? But we noticed that you were very comfortable at not energy fighting the F-15, and you just seem to be very comfortable at being the slowest guy, but staying inside his turn circle and getting some really fucking accurate shots. Was that the plan for this round?
Okay, so I have a few philosophies. Generally on the merge, my philosophy is the first turn determines the fight, so I'm willing to dump almost all of my energy to get a shot, because every opportunity to get a kill is an opportunity to end the fight. That's the way I look at it. And then when it comes to the normal turning, you know, as I think what's his mover says, you know, like, it's okay to sacrifice speed for an angle.
100%
shot.
Yeah.
So it's just a philosophy. I think it's... Yeah, I'm not the most conservative when it comes to my plan. You know, I'm always trying to get the angle for the shot, and if that means I bleed speed and lose position, well, at least I try. At least I got to take a shot, you know.
Exactly.
So,
yeah.
It definitely worked out. Like you say, man, a lot of people sort of incorrectly think that you have to. Do you know what I mean? Because they hear speed is life, and then they think, oh, I have to be fast, have to be fast. But like you said, do you know what I mean? Even Mover pointed out that sometimes. A lot of the time, in fact, the best thing to do is just work yourself into that position, squat the jet, get rid of all that airspeed, move the nose, and then take a shot. And that was something that we've seen you do time after time again. You were the slowest guy. You just stayed inside the circle, and you were so accurate with that gun as well, dude. That was super impressive to watch.
Thank you.
But Higgy, you need to. So where are you from? I know you're from Glasgow, but in terms of where are you from like DC, where the fuck have you been, bro? How have we never seen you before? Where the fuck have you been hiding?
I used to play a lot of DTS, and then I went away and played iRacing for a little bit, and I come back.
Yeah, and you rocked up with 1.5, so I take it you've not flown for a while then?
No, I haven't, no.
God damn it.
I need to adjust my graphics settings, they're a little bit funky.
I need to start drinking whatever water you're drinking over there in Glasgow, Higgy. I think I need to get myself some.
I think you know what kind of water we're drinking.
Does it begin with a B and come in a fucking glass bottle?
Yep.
Awesome, dude. I can't say enough good about you guys, honestly. I mean, I'll be honest, Squirtle, I was rooting for my man Higgy just because he's a Scotsman and I'm a Scotsman, and I wanted to see a Scotsman do well. But yeah, props to you, sir. Fantastically flown. It was very nice to see someone do something different rather than kind of going for the traditional energy fight, and you really did make it work, dude. Every time someone tried to energy fight you, you stayed in their circle and made them pay for it. So yeah, hopefully we'll see you guys a lot more in the future for some of the other events that we're running along. Please don't be a stranger. But yeah, for your very first DCS tournament, Squirtle, done yourself. I'm incredibly proud, sir. And was this your first one as well, Higgy?
Yes.
Fucking hell, no disrespect. A couple of fucking PvP event virgins in the final, taking us all to school. Congratulations, guys. So Higgy,
I do want to say, I have been playing DCS for probably over 6 years, and I do only PvP, I don't do PvE. So I do have a bit of experience.
Good man. Good man. I'm a bit of a PvP elitist myself, so anybody else that flies to PvP is good with me. But no offense to the PvE guys, but yeah. So Higgy, you'll get to choose free T-shirts, Higgy, from Wild Weasel Apparel. So give me a shout and I'll sort you out with how we're going to get those delivered to you. And likewise, Squirtle, you'll also be able to choose 2 T-shirts from the Wild Weasel Apparel store. I'll pop the link in TeamSpeak for you guys, and then you can let me know on Discord which T-shirts you would like, and I'll put you in touch with the guy that can get them to you.
All right.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, gentlemen. Thank you. We'll see you next time. Thank you so much for taking part. Congratulations, guys.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Channel switched.
Ah, good God, guys. Good God. What an event. I got to go to work now, bro. I got to go to work all hyped up. Thanks to the guys in the 104th that helped me run this event, in particular to Tiger, Knight, and Eons, who weren't flying but were helping, and also to Bullet as well. Bullet was flying and sort of doing a bit of both and helping out there. Shout out to the sponsors, guys, to Wild Weasel. Thank you for putting up the prizes. And thanks to all you guys for joining us on the stream and basically contributing to a bit of the pressure. There's always a bit of extra pressure when they know that people are watching them. So, yeah, Top Gun and Volleyball, guys. I will see you next time. Maverick out.